Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Welcome here tonight to Cardinals Field in Newport, Rhode Island, where this evening the Newport Gulls will be taking on the Holyoke Giants for the second and final time here in the regular season. Newport owns the season series so far, 1-0 on game one up in Holyoke, Massachusetts earlier this season. The 2-game interleague season series will wrap up here at Cardinals Field in Newport. We're looking to sweep the season series of the Holyoke Giants. Newport coming off a stellar win last night in North Adams, Massachusetts, shutting out the Steeplecats 4-0. Newport first place in the NECBL Southern Division with just a week and a half to go here in the regular season. We have a lot of baseball action coming up shortly. Mike Coombs is next here on the NECBL Broadcast Network. Back here now at Cardinals Field in Newport, Rhode Island, Nick Lehman alongside Newport Gulls field manager Mike Coombs. Coach, how are you doing today?
How you doing, buddy? Good, and you?
Not too bad. Newport Gulls with a pretty impressive victory last night over the North Adams Steeplecats.
Wow, well, that was a good game. We had a 4-run lead going to the ninth. Lynn came in and shut them down, and we beat them 4-0, and they got a good club. They got a real good club, and they're in it, you know, all the way, too, with us. But we put them a few more runs up on the board than they did, and our pitching was pretty good and timely hitting. So there it is.
Newport Gulls, who are we going to see on the night tonight for them?
Tonight we got who we got tonight? I have to look at my book. I forgot. Mike Lurie. Mike Lurie has got the got the ball tonight.
So Lurie on the hill will pitch against this Holyoke team, and Newport did have a pretty successful game against Holyoke a couple of weeks back.
Yeah, Pat McEnany threw the ball very well against Holyoke, and you know. We got a right-hander going tonight, and we had a left-hander that night, so you never know. I mean, every team in this league can play.
Some heavy rains downtown here last night really drenched this field. It's in a pretty tough shape. Right behind us, the ground screw working on it, trying to get it ready. How do you think that's going to impact the play tonight?
You know, you just go out and play, and, you know, I think the field's taking it very good. He's got a pretty good drainage system, so we'll just tee it up and go.
So just about a week and a half go to the playoffs. Do you think this is a championship team right here?
You know, every team that I've ever coached, I've always told them they're a championship team. This team here, every time when we get in the circle out there at the end of the game, I tell them defense wins championships. And that's my saying the rest of the way through. And You can mark it down. Any team that goes to the championships is going to have to play great defense. And right now we've struggled a little bit with the defense, but I'm going to put it in their brain. I'm going to keep on harping on it, emphasizing it. Defense wins championships. And, you know, whether they're going to be a championship team, they're a championship team in my heart right now. I've seen them. I've battled with them. They've come through some tough games and done a good job. So, you know, you hope that the final deal is that you're on the top end of it and you win the whole thing. But, you know, you got to take one pitch, one out, one inning at a time.
So defense, the absolute key for the Gulls as we go into the last stretch here. And finally, what's the injury report look like right now?
Paul Nardozzi's got a little bit of a knee injury, a little strain. John Dishart's coming back a little bit off of a little something in his arm. I'm not exactly sure what that is. All I know is that he's got to work that kink out.
Did you see Jet Ruiz step into the batter's box last night?
Yeah, Jet got in there last night, and hopefully he's on his way back and we could use him. Andy Lentz is not going to be in the lineup tonight. His left foot is a little injured, so he'll go see Tim, the trainer, and figure that one out.
And how about Richie Lentz?
Yeah, I just said Richie. Richie's got a – oh, Richie. No, that was Andy. You're right. Richie is just through another bullpen, so he should be ready to go by Saturday.
Newport Gulls field manager Mike Coombs, good luck tonight.
Thanks, Nick. All right, buddy.
That's our pregame visit with Mike Coombs. Ground screw behind me continues to work to get this field ready. First pitch as well as the starting lineups are next here on the NECBL Broadcast Network. And back here at Cardinals Field in Newport, Rhode Island, with the starting lineups for today's ball game. First, we'll give you the starting lineups for the Holyoke Giants. Here's Mike Lord.
Thank you, Nick. For the Holyoke Giants, leading off will be designated hitter Phil Allen, taking a day off from his usual center field position. Batting second at second base, Billy Bartram. Batting third, the third baseman, Brian Adamski. Batting cleanup, the right fielder, Mike Lyon. Batting fifth at first base, Thomas Hill. Batting sixth, the shortstop, Vincent Gutierrez. Batting seventh, the center fielder, Jason Rago. Batting eighth, the catcher, Pat Irvin. And batting ninth, the left fielder, Justin Albert.
For the home Newport Gulls, leading off will be the center fielder, Tim Henry. Batting second, second baseman, Matt Bouchard. Third baseman, Jeff Miller, bats third. And cleanup, Jim Murphy, the first baseman. John Molinco will be the catcher, batting fifth. Scott Brown has moved down a little bit in the sixth spot, the right fielder. After him will be Chris Dominguez, the designated hitter. Batting eighth, Brian Mitzel, the left fielder. And rounding out the order for the Newport Gulls, Ryan Arcadia, the shortstop. It's Little League night here at Cardinals Field. Let's take it down to the field right now.
Softball District 2 champions. We'd like to take a moment to recognize each one of them. They just stand for Emily Bach, Morgan Sullivan, Jackie Correa, Taylor Gilman, Jesse Sullivan, Shannon Grizzly, George Bullock, Caitlin Eggerman, Lauren Samar, Ashley Sanders, Glenn Murphy, and Mary O'Connor. And how about a big round of applause for the coaching staff? Manager Paul Murphy. Coaches Jim Correa. And Charlie Roachford. Congratulations.
So a big congratulations to the Middletown Little League. Well, the District 2 Rhode Island State Champions. Huge congratulations to them being honored out there on the field. Newport Gulls General Manager out there right now, Chuck Paver, with a member of the United States Military for the first pitch ceremony. We'll take it back down to the field for that.
Please welcome Senator Teresa Paver Wee, who is the Rhode Island Senate Majority Leader. Mike Grabowski of the 43rd Military Police Brigade deployed to Iraq. This unit is due home in October of 2006. He has been deployed in Iraq for 18 months. Give it a go. Yeah. Oh, Stevens, the Newport Director from the office of Senator Lincoln Chafee. Later on in
So a whole slew of our special guests down there, including a Lieutenant Colonel of the United States Army, as well as Rhode Island Senate Majority Leader Teresa Piper Reed throwing out first pitches. Let's take it down to the field once again for the national anthem.
27-year veteran special agent of the United States Naval Criminal Investigation Service, assigned here in Newport. The special agent Brown has always been involved in music and played the trombone with the band of the Fighting Irish while a student at Notre Dame. Special Agent Brown continues to sing at St. Lucie's Church in Middletown and at the NCIS Awards ceremony. Last July, he performed the national anthem and the Navy hymn aboard the USS Constitution in Boston Harbor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Paul Graff, the singing special agent.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the
How about those pregame ceremonies here at Tidings Field in Newport? We're almost ready for baseball as the umpires for tonight's game calling balls and strikes behind the plate with John Degalama and Kevin Doble, the base umpire. Nick Lehman alongside Mike Lord here on the NECBL Broadcast Network on Team Line and locally on Newport County Television Public Access TV 18. A great baseball game coming up shortly here as the Newport Gulls take on the Holyoke Giants. Now let's talk about a little bit about the starting pitcher tonight for Holyoke. At starter
for the Holyoke Giants, Dan Gallino. This is his ninth appearance. He's got no wins and two losses. An ERA of 2.64. He's pitched 30 innings, given up 24 hits, 13 runs, 9 of those earned, 11 walks, 16 strikeouts. Opponents hitting 233 against him. And Gallino had a nice relief appearance in the victory over the Sanford Mainers a couple of weeks ago up in Sanford.
And tonight for the Newport Gulls, their starting pitcher will be Mike Lurie. Lurie, a 3.91 earned average, 1-1 in six appearances, making a sixth start here tonight, seventh overall appearance. Lurie, 25 and a third innings pitcher, he's given up 30, hit 17 runs, 11 of them earned. He's walked 8, struck out 14, and given up 2 doubles, 2 home runs, throwing a wild pitch and hit a pair of batters. Around the league right now. Tonight, the Lowell Americans taking on the Concord Quarry Dogs underway right now at 6:30. We'll be underway in just a few minutes here as the Manchester Silkworms and Pittsfield Dukes play up at Wacona Park underway in about 30 minutes. Two other 7 o'clock games to report tonight, North Adams Steeplecats at the Danbury Westerners, and the Sanford Mainers are playing at the Keene Swamp Bats. Torrington at Manchester was rained out last night. Concord at Danbury rained out last night. Keene over Vermont 4-3. Holyoke did defeat Lowell 3-2 and was a pretty close game, threatened by rain initially, but it held off up there. Sanford over Pittsfield 9-1 in an early afternoon game there. And the Vermont Mountaineers did shut out Keene 4-0 in the first game of their doubleheader. And of course, last night the Newport Gulls defeated the North Adams Steeplecats 4-0 to take first place now by 4.5 games in the NECBL Southern Division. Newport 22-9, North Adams 18-14. Took third place, Torrington Twisters at 16-14, just 5.5 out. Manchester Silkworms on the playoff spot right now, 14-16, 7.5 back as the Newport Gulls take the field. Pittsfield Dukes are in fifth place, 12-18 in the elimination spot for the playoffs, 9.5 games back. And Danbury Western has ran out the NECBL South, 11-19, 10.5 back. Mike Lord will run you down the Northern Division standings.
The Vermont Mountaineers, 22-12, are in first place. Sanford Mainers, 19-12 in second. And the next four spots are pretty close. Holyoke and Keene are tied at 14-17, and they play each other twice this weekend. Concord is in fifth at 13-18, and Lowell, who the Giants defeated 3-2 last night, are 10-19. Now the Giants have defeated Concord and Lowell back-to-back to move them up into third place.
So we'll be back with the first pitch next. Nick Lima alongside Mike Lord back in a moment. And we'll be ready for baseball right after this as we continue on the NECBL Broadcast Network. So we go to the top of the first inning as the designated hitter, Phil Allen, for the Holyoke Giants, who is ready to get things started offensively for them. Allen bats from the left side of the plate. The first pitch from Willery. A fastball take on the outside corner for strike one.
For the first time this season, Phil Allen, not in center field, got the night off, so he's DHing.
And next delivery, swinging a high fly ball popped up left field, charging on, and this ball will drop as the shortstop can't get to it. And on at first with a leadoff single here on the second pitch is Phil Allen. That ball just dropped out there in left field. It popped up and no one could get to it.
Nick, if the Giants are going to come out of here with the win, Phil Allen has to be on base. He's got 15 steals and 16 attempts, including two stolen bases against Lowell last night, stealing third.
Of course, the Newport Gulls is a team that doesn't steal much at all. You take Arcadia, who has 10 steals out of the equation, and Allen has more steals than the entire Gulls team put together. So a runner at first, nobody out, and here comes Billy Mottram, who steps up to the plate. One on, nobody out. Lurie comes to the set, to the belt, and to the plate instead of check on the runner at first, and diving back in is Allen.
Yeah, my 4 years with the Giants haven't had too much success here at Cardines Field. Then again, not many people have the last 2 years.
Newport Gulls have won three championships here. The pitch, swinging a line drive into center field, falls for a hit in front of the center fielder. And on at first with a single is Mottram. And just like that, the Giants have two straight hits here with nobody out to lead things off in the first.
Nick, one of the jelly spots for the Giants, they're batting 149 with the bases loaded, and they had the bases loaded three times last night against Lowell, and they got one hit out of those three bases loaded tries, and that was enough to give them the 3-2 win. But if you're going to beat a team like Newport or Sanford or Vermont, you need to do better than that when the bases are juiced.
So nobody out, two runners on. Here in the first, Brian Ademski comes up to the plate. Ademski, third man in the lineup, awaits the pitch. It's a fastball missing inside, a little bit high. Ball one from Mike Lurie. And as we mentioned in the pregame show, Lurie coming into the game tonight, making his sixth start of the season, seventh overall appearance, at 3.91 earned run average. Comes to the set, checks the runner. The 1-0 pitch. Fastball is taken on the outside corner at the knees. 1-1, the count will even here to Ademski. Lurie, 25 and third innings pitched, has given up 30 hits, 17 runs, 11 of them earned, walking 12, striking out 14. He's given up a pair of home runs and a pair of doubles in the season as this pitch is swung on and missed for strike two. Chasing an off-speed pitch low in the dirt was Ademski, and he's fallen behind here, 1-2. Lurie trying to settle down a little bit. He's given up a pair of little bloop singles here to the two leadoff men for Holyoke. Nobody out. 1-2 the count on Ademski from the set. The pitch. Swing and a miss, he struck him out. So Brian Ademski's fans for the first out of the ball game. Now two on with one out for the cleanup hitter, Mike Lyon.
Mike Lurie did a terrific job getting Ademski to chase the outside pitch. Two pitches in a row, striking him out.
Lyon comes up to the plate now. A 223 average, two homers, 18 runs batted in. And that cleanup spot well, leading the team in RBIs and swings on the first pitch, misses it, strike one. Chased a off-speed pitch that was low and away.
Yeah, Mike Lyon has struck out many times chasing the low off-speed pitch.
Lurie gets the sign from his catcher, John Molicone. Checks the runner. The 0-1 pitch. Fastball is taken in the inside corner, strike two. Defense for the Newport Gulls, Jim Murphy at first, Matt Bouchard at second, Ryan Ikea the shortstop, Jeff Miller at third, outfield left to right, Brian Mitzel, Tim Henry, and Scott Brown. John Molicone catches Mike Lurie, who gets the sign from his catcher. And now likes what he sees. A check on the runner. The 0-2 delivery. Swing and a miss. He struck him out. And just as you said, faces that low and away breaking pitch. And there it was again. And there he chased it. And he fans back-to-back strikeouts here for Lurie.
So the Giants in danger again of stranding runners in scoring position. First two batters got on. And then Mike Lurie, like you said, Nick, really settled down, striking out Adamski and Lyon.
Back-to-back singles followed by back-to-back strikeouts. Two outs for Thomas Hill. Hill, first baseman for the Giants, takes the first pitch in there for a strike. So Lurie has struck out 16 batters on the season now as he gets set with the 0-1. Swinging a hard hit, ground ball bouncing through the shortstop by Keady. Off the flips easy way to second for the out that retires the side. So they waste off the leadoff singles by Allen and Montrum. We've played half an inning here from Cardines Field. It's the Holyoke Giants nothing. The Newport Gulls coming up here on the NECBL Broadcast Network. And back here again in Cardines Field, we go to the last of the first. No score here as the Newport Gulls come up to the plate for the first time tonight. Tim Henry, the leadoff batter, center fielder for Newport, will start things off for them from the left side of the plate against Dan Gooley in the pitch. Fastball to the outside, ball one. And what can you tell us about Dan, Mike?
Well, Dan's got a very good break-in pitch, excellent fastball, and he's come off a couple of outstanding relief appearances, giving up no runs in his last five innings.
The next pitch is taken low and away to Henry, ball two. Not a huge crowd yet here at Cardines, but the stands beginning to fill in a little bit now. And on Wednesday night, the 2-0, taken for a strike, 2-1, Murphy, or rather Henry, batting 306. 1 point behind Jeff Miller for a second in the batting average statistics for Newport. No homers, 11 runs batted in. Pops this one up to the left side, foul and out of play.
Of course, the Giants trying to avenge an earlier 5-0 loss to the Gulls, where the Gulls had a 5-run sixth inning. But other than that, it was a pretty evenly played game.
The 2-2, swinging another foul to the left. Pat Mankinini earning the win in that ball game. With a pitcher's duel going right through that sixth inning, and the Gulls had a breakout of offense, which came out of nowhere, really. Two balls, two strikes to count on Henry. The pitch. Swing, a high fly ball popped up, center field charging on. The center fielder, now the left fielder comes in, Justin Albert, to put away Henry for the inning's first out.
That was good communications by the Giant outfield. I thought Jason Rago and Justin Albert were going to collide on that fly ball.
So here comes Matt Bouchard. Bouchard to face off against Dan Golino here. Base is loaded, one out. We're here in the last of the first, the pitch. Breaking pitch is outside for ball one. Bouchard batting 284. A homer, 13 runs batted in, sends this one into right field. There in right center is Jason Rago for the inning second out. So a couple flyouts to the outfield here, and we'll see Jeff Miller as the heart of the order comes up for Newport. Miller, second on the team in average at 307. Also is second in RBIs with 17. Despite joining the team late, he's only played now in 23 games. of the 31. This is the 32nd game. The pitch is in there for a strike to Miller. He's also hit a pair of home runs in the season, but none here yet at Cardines Field. The 0-1. Swing and a miss, strike two. Galeno, one pitch away here from retiring the side in order. Big Jim Murphy waits on deck. There are two outs. Base is empty. The 0-2 pitch just inside the fastball. Ball one. Galeno has a sign from his catcher. The 1-2. Swinging up. A pop-up. This way playable on the infield. The third baseman, Brian Ademski, calls for it. Inning over. 1-2-3. Goal to Gulls here in the first. We've played one complete here at Cardines Field. No score between the Gulls and the Giants and the NECBL Broadcast Network. A reminder that this copyright telecast is the exclusive property of the Tyasini Crew and Newport Gulls, presented by the authority of the NECBL Broadcast Network, and may not be reproduced, re-recorded, or retransmitted in any form. And the accounts and descriptions of this game cannot be disseminated without the express written permission of Tyasini, the Newport Gulls, and the Commissioner's Office of the Northern Collegiate Baseball League. We go to the second here at Cardines Field, no score, and leading things off here for the Giants will be Vincent Gutierrez. Out there for a second inning of work, Mike Lurie ready, winds, kicks, and delivers. Fastball on the outside corner, strike one to the lefty Gutierrez. On this season, a .222 batting average, no homers, nine runs batted in, has four doubles. The pitch, swing and a miss, strike two. And Gutierrez quickly in a hole here, nothing in two. A pair of leadoff singles given up by Lurie in the first. Both runners trended on as they get the next three in order on two strikeouts. The pitch outside, ball one. Lurie will hope to settle down here in the second. Last thing you want to have is a ball game with a lot of base runners. That'll work your pitch count up pretty fast. And the Newport Gulls want to rest their bullpen here. Still in the middle of a long stretch. The 1-2 outside, ball two. The next day off for Newport will be the All-Star game. And Newport sending seven players to that, along with their entire coaching staff. Two balls, two strikes, the count evens on Gutierrez. Lurie gets the sign from Molico, ready. The 2-2 pitch. Swinging a foul to the left, and the count will remain 2-2. But Mike, what kind of all-stars are we going to see from the Holyoke Giants?
They're going to send starting pitcher Jay Monty, who won his fifth game last night against no losses, and Phil Allen, the designated hitter tonight, is an alternate in center field. Those are the only two Giants that are headed to Keene.
How about the home run derby?
They're sending Brian Ademski.
Ademski, so we just saw him in the top of the first. Mention that next time he comes around in the order. 2-2 the count, Lurie ready. His pitch. Swinging another foul to the left off the netting up there that protects the fans up the left field line. Still filling in here. Not a huge crowd, maybe 1,000 or so at this point. Lurie. Ready. That next delivery. Swinging a weak hit, ground ball rolling softly to the third baseman. Up Miller. Fires to first, gets away from Murphy, and going into second here will be Gutierrez. He's going to slide in safely as the ball cannot be recovered out there. And just like that, the Giants will have a runner at second here with nobody out. Once again, Lurie will have to work here with nobody out and a runner on base.
It looks like Jeff Miller let go of the ball just a fraction of a second before he wanted to. Jim Murphy made a nice leaping attempt for it and almost had it, but the ball got by him, enabling Gutierrez to have a single plus an error on the throw. So the second time tonight, the Giants get the leadoff batter on.
So an E5 charge to Miller as Rago comes up to the plate. The runner at second, and it is the go-ahead run for the Giants. Lurie, look at him. The pitch. Swing and a miss, strike one. Rago, 162, one homer, nine runs batted in. Bats here at Gutierrez at second. just the fourth error from Miller of the season. As Lurie ready, the 0-1. Low and outside. 1-1 the count even on Rago. Pat Irvine due up after him. Lurie in his second season in a Newport Gulls uniform. Comes set at the belt. The pitch. Swinging a check swing grounder. The first baseman Murphy will pick it up and tag the bag at first for the inning first out. However, advancing to third is Gutierrez, and the Giants have a runner 90 feet from the plate here with just one out for Jason Rago.
Yeah, Nick, right here, the Giants really need to cash in to try to establish some momentum because the Gulls, batting 251 as a team, are capable of a big inning like they had up in Holyoke when they had five runs in the sixth inning to run away with the 5-0 victory. So the Giants need to establish some early momentum.
So here comes Pat Irvine with a runner at third, one away. The pitch is inside, ball one. Irvine of Elon University, hometown of Westwood, Massachusetts. Bat here against Lurie. Goes to the work. The runner at third, one away. The 1-0 pitch. Outside and low, ball two. Lurie. A right-handed pitcher out of Villanova University. He's finishing up his junior year there. He'll be entering his senior year this fall. Hometown of Gillette, New Jersey. Comes set, the 2-0. Swinging a line shot, hooking foul up the third base line. That'll be the first strike to Irvine. 2-1 the count.
Not much foul room here down the left field line at Cardinals Field. Any pop-up is going to go foul.
Not only that, but a lot of outs that normally would be recorded in other ballparks aren't recorded here because of that. Almost no foul territory in the right field side. The pitch, swinging a hard hit, bouncy ball. The second baseman stabs it, flips it in his hand, throws the first in time, but scoring from third easily is Vincent Gutierrez, and the error comes back to hurt Newport here as the Holyoke Giants take a 1-0 lead.
Good job by Jason Rago and Pat Irvine to hit the ball on the right side of the infield to allow Gutierrez to advance to third and then subsequently to home to give the Giants the first run of the game.
And the first pitch into Albert is missing for ball one. So crossing the plate, Gutierrez, 1-0 Holyoke here. Once again, the Gulls have fallen behind early in the ball game. It's been a trend all season long as the 1-0 pitch is foul tipped to the backstop, 1-1. And we heard Newport Gulls field manager Mike Coombs tell us in our pregame show that errors and unnecessary errors are the thing that will kill a ball team, as the 1-1 is missing low. Defense wins championships, he told us, and lately, the Newport Gulls defense has not been all that stellar. They've had the second-ranked defense all season long behind Vermont, but they've been dropping down lately. The 2-1 is in there for a strike. The count even at 2-2 on Albert. Two outs, a run home here for Holyoke. We're here in the second. 1-0, the Giants. The 2-2. Swinging a little flail left field. This ball will drop in for a hit. On at first with a two-out single, Justin Albert. And we cycle back around to the top of the order. Already here in the second, Phil Allen. Allen?
I spoke to Mike Coombs before the game. He said the same exact thing about defense winning championships. The Giants lost about three games because of errors at the most inopportune times and errant pickoff throws, too.
Allen single back in the first to lead off this ball game. Stands in at the plate. Albert at first, the pitch. Check swing as it's in there for a strike, nothing in one. Two outs. We're here in the top of the second. Mike Lurie gets ready to pitch to the lefty Allen. He's single on the second pitch he saw last time. The 0-1 delivery. Low and inside. Ball one. A couple nights ago in Pittsfield, Newport Gulls had a 7-5 loss. Committed five errors in that game. We're already in error here tonight, has resulted in unearned run. But 1-1 instead, a check on the runner at first, diving in is Justin Albert.
Hey, talk about errors. The Giants defeated the Concord Quarry Dogs 9-5. Nine errors committed between the two teams. A game called the Comedy of Errors.
A pitch. Swinging a line drive. Base hit in the center field. Hitting second is Albert. He's going to hold up there as the ball is recovered very quickly in shallow center by Tim Henry. And a pair of singles here. With two outs, we'll bring up Billy Montrum, who singled his last time. Allen on the second hit of the ball game. And the inning goes on here with two outs. As Montrum steps up.
Yeah, Justin Albert is a relief pitcher. He pitched five innings of scoreless relief against the Concord Quarry Dogs. I told him he should change his middle initial at K. He had five straight strikeouts.
Billy Montrum. Takes the first pitch in there for strike one. Like a slider from Laurie. The crowd's still filling in pretty well now at Cardines. As the 0-1 delivery is inside ball one. Pretty good evening for baseball here. Game time temperature about 81 degrees under partly cloudy skies. A light breeze floats in as the humidity has been lifted in the ballpark. A little bit humid earlier on in the day. Laurie comes set. The 1-1 delivery. In there for a strike one and two. Hey, right. Newport Gulls Tigers TV field microphone in place here to hear the crowd and, more importantly, the crack of the bat or the snap of the glove. For the first time this season, our microphone in place, we put it up here with the 1-2 pitch. Swinging a ground ball bouncer. Second baseman has it, flips to first, for the out, retires the side. The Holyoke Giants leave two runners, they've left four. However, they do get the go-ahead run home here in the second after 1.5, 1-0 Giants on the NECBL Broadcast Network. From Washington So we go to the last of the second here at Cardines Field in Newport, Rhode Island. Gulls now trailing this one, 1-0. Jim Murphy takes the first pitch, outside ball one. And Galeno ready with the next delivery. It's taken for a strike, 1-1. The count will even up on Murphy. Jim will start the All-Star game for Newport. At first base with a Southern Division, the pitch, swinging a hard hit ground ball, up with it, the third baseman. Ademski throws the first. A low throw, but picked by Thomas Hill for the inning's first out. We just had some muffins delivered to us. If you could tell us a little bit more about those, Mike.
Well, Phil Rosenfield's wife dropped them off to us. The blueberries are outstanding. You can tell they're homemade. They're not dehydrated like some of those store brand muffins.
Absolutely delicious muffins that we're eating between innings here. As the Newport Gulls and the Holyoke Giants do baseball battle in front of us. The pitch. Low, missing the fastball to John Mollicone. Mollicone and Iannetta have been switching in the starting catcher almost nightly lately. So Mollicone gets a start tonight to pitch the catch for Lurie. And he takes the next pitch, strike one. Dan Galeno has been getting ahead of batters. He tied four straight here. Next delivery, swinging a high fly ball in a center field, way back it goes. This ball will be off the top of the wall. Mollicone hits first, he's gonna go into second easily and has a one out stand up double. There's the first hit and the first base runner for the Gulls as Mollicone misses a home run by about 5 feet out there in left center.
Yeah, Justin Albert stood there in medium center field and all of a sudden had to quickly backpedal as the ball carried a lot further than he thought. And fortunately for the Giants, the left field fence is about 20 feet high.
28 feet high from right center all the way to the third baseline here at Cardines. From right center to the third baseline, the fence varies a little bit. It's about 12 feet in some areas, and there's one spot where it's about 16 feet. Here comes Scott Brown, the pitch. Low and away, ball one. Brown knows how to hit a home run at Cardines Field. He had a few last year. Three overall home runs this season. Grand slam here last season. A 1-0 pitch with a runner at second. Galeno ready. It's a fastball missing outside. 1-1. Big Chris Dominguez waits on deck. Chris will represent Newport in the Home Run Derby on Sunday up in Keene for the NECBL All-Star Game. Galeno ready. Now steps off as Brown asks for time.
And there should be plenty of home runs hit up at Keene. It's only 310 feet the right center field.
A very shallow fence out there all the way around. The 2-0. Swinging a line drive grounded to the second baseman. Up with it is Montrum, who throws the first in time. Advancing to third is Molico, and the Gulls had the tying run 90 feet away for Dominguez.
So even though Scott Brown didn't get on, he at least hit the ball a second, allowing the runner to get to third base, much like the Giants did in the top half of the second inning.
Dominguez comes in to the game with a 1.86 average, 6 homers, 14 runs batted in, takes the first pitch for strike one. Chris was tied with Matt Arbor and his teammate Jim Murphy for the league lead in home runs. We'll wait the 0-1. Check swing, he didn't go. And the count even at 1-1 on Chris. Standing in at third, John Molikoon, who had the one out double. The Gulls don't want to waste that here. Two away, the 1-1 to Chris. Swinging a ground ball, bounces to the third baseman, has it, boots it, but it catches it in the air, throws to first. In time, a very good play by Ademski, who almost booted that ball and was able to recover it out of his glove in time.
Yeah, the ball bounced off of his glove. It went up in the air and it landed in his throwing hand. How lucky can you get there? And then he made the quick throw to get Dominguez, who really hustled down the line by about a step.
That run gets away from Ademski. It's a run for Newport. However, instead they strand a runner after two complete. It's Holyoke 1, Newport nothing on the NECBL Broadcast Network. Back here now at Cardines Field in Newport, Rhode Island, we go to the top of the third here as Ryan Ademski gets ready to lead things off for the Giants. The pitch from Lurie in the dirt and outside, ball one.
Of course, the song you heard in between innings, I Love Rock and Roll by Joan Jett back in 1982, spent 7 weeks at number one.
Real classic. We'd like to have some interesting bumper music here. Here's the 1-0. Is taken on the inside corner for a strike one. 1-1 the count on Ademski, who struck out in the first, one of two strikeouts. Victims, both in the first, for Mike Lurie. His pitch is missing, low and away. Two balls, one strike, the counter on Ademski. Mike Lyon due up after him, then Thomas Hill. We're here in the third, 1-0 Giants. The pitch. Swing and a high fly ball, rel hit right field of line, and leaping out there is Tim Henry for to make the catch for the inning's first out. Henry, a leaping catch. Caught that ball a couple feet off the ground out there, and there's one away in the first inning.
Nice play by Henry, because the way the fence cuts out, if that ball goes over his head and ricochets off the fence, it could roll a deep center field with the Ademski speed. He may have gotten three bases out of it.
We've seen inside the park home runs hit into that territory, including one by Scott Brown. Pitch to Lyon. Outside, ball one. Lurie, key facet, the Gulls championship season in 2005, hoping to do so again as the 1-0 is bounced right back to him. Lurie will easily flip to first, and it gets away from Murphy. That should have been an out. Lurie was with a very casual flip to first there. Gets away from Murphy, who dropped the ball. And reaching at first base is Lyon. You don't see that one happen every day.
No, usually a pitch will underhand it to the first baseman rather than lob it like that. But like you said, Nick, that was a very casual lob. And I'll tell you, if you're Mike Coombs, that has really got to get under your skin.
Coombs will certainly not be too happy about that. And now he charges an error on Lurie in E1. And that's the Gull's second error of the ball game. And that's not good defense right here. The pitch. Swinging a miss, strike one to Thomas Hill. Newport already with two errors, and this may hurt them here with the heart of the order due up right now. Runner at first, one out. Hill bounced a short to end the first inning. That's here in the third. Lurie with the sign. Comes to the set. And fires. The runner goes. Swing and a miss. Here's Marlon comes through to second. Well in time. And just like that, the error is erased here as Lyon is caught stealing. And once again, the Newport Gulls have caught a runner. They caught three Steeplecats last night.
I'll tell you, it seems like Marlicone has caught more people stealing than the Walmart detective. Excellent throw to get Lyons out by quite a distance.
Now here's the next pitch to Hill. Swing and a miss, strike three. So Lyon caught stealing for the inning second out, and Hill fans here for the out that retires the side. The Giants get a runner on the error, having lost, caught stealing. We have played through 2.5 here from Cardine. Still, Holyoke 1, Newport nothing on the NECBL Broadcast Network. And this game is being brought to you today as a co-producer of the Timmins Tigers TV crew and Newport Gulls Broadcasting. Tigers TV is an all-volunteer, school-based video production organization based out of Tiverton High School in Tiverton, Rhode Island. Since 2003, Tigers TV has covered over 600 town meetings, school events, baseball games, and other sports events throughout Tiverton, Newport County, and all of Rhode Island, southeast of Massachusetts. Tigers TV programming can be seen on Newport County TV Public Access 18 on video DVD, as well as on Fall River Public Access and Rhode Island State Worldwide Interconnects, with select programming archived and broadcast live on the web at www.tivschools.com. So we go to the third inning here. As for the Newport Gulls, leading off will be Brian Mitzel. First pitch to him, in there for a strike. Galeno ready. The 0-1. Swinging a hard shot up the middle. Galeno can't get to it. The second baseman stabs at Monstrum, throws the first in time to get Mitzel. 4-3 on the ground out, and the Gulls have had four straight outs as ground outs, followed by three fly outs here. So no strikeouts for Galeno, who has retired.
Yeah, Giants caught a break that Galeno did not get a glove on the ball. He more than likely would have knocked it over towards base, and Mitzel would have beat it out for an infield single.
The pitch is in there for a strike. Pick up a little bit of interference here. Coming from the fire station across the street, the 0-1 is outside low, ball one. Picked up a little bit of audio interference and threw us for a loop. 1-1 the count here to Ryan Arcadia, the pitch. Missing low. Sometimes the radio signals at the fire station across the street in West Marlboro Street from Cardine's Field here interfere with our audio signal just a little bit. The 2-1. Swinging a foul to the right. This one get over the fire station and over everything in right. Well out of play. Count will even up at 2 balls, 2 strikes on Ryan Arcadia. Ryan at 297, making his 18th start in a Gulls uniform. 3 RBIs on the season. The pitch. Swinging a ground ball roller. The shortstop ranging to his right has it. A long throw to first. It will be 9-in time, and Arcadia is on with a 1-out infield single.
Yeah, that was a nice play by Vincent Gutierrez just to get to the ball. He had the run to his right, and then by the time he picked up the ball, he turned around and made a good throw to Thomas Hill, but he couldn't put much on it because his momentum was carrying him away from the first base bag.
Here comes Tim Henry. Henry flew out to left to start things off for the Gulls in the last of the first, so trailless ball came 1-0. Henry stands in. The pitch, missing low and away, ball one. Dan Galeno fires a bullet back to first, and Arcadia has to dive in very quickly. Ryan, just the second base runner of the night for Newport, does have 10 steals in the season. Leads the team by far in that category. 10-for-10 in stolen bases. A 1-0 from Dan. Swinging a foul to the left. Running on that pitch was Arcadia. He'll have to head back as the count will even at 1-1 on Tim Henry. Matt Bouchard waits on deck. This game, very similar to the last game these two teams played up in Holyoke a few weeks back. Very little offense through the first few innings. 1-1 the count, the pitch. Hitting inside a fastball, ball two on Henry. Tim steps in, taps the plate. He stares down Dan Galino, who fires another rocket into first. And once again, Arcadia, messing up his uniform, will have to dive in. Grounds crew did a very good job getting this field ready for tonight's ball game. After the heavy rains last night, the thunderstorms that moved through the area, the 2-1 pitch in the dirt and low, ball three. A hitter's count now on Henry. A walk here would bring up Matt Bouchard and then the heart of the order. Newport looking for a big inning here. Henry represents the go-ahead run, the tying run at first in the form of Arcadia. Dan Galino gets the sign, comes to the set. The pitch. Fastball is missing low and away. Ball four. And Henry takes his base. So a one-out walk puts runners at first and second for Matt Bouchard, who flew out to center. Bouchard, the NECBL Player of the Week for week five.
And with Arcadia's speed, any kind of a base hit is going to score the tying run for the Gulls.
Bouchard, a Rhode Island native, came in tonight at 284. A homer, 13 RBI. His home run came against Keene up in Keene. Will play Keene again on Sunday as he sends the first pitch into right field, popped up. Billy Montrum, or rather Mike Lyon is there. And takes it for the out. So quickly two down here for Jeff Miller, who popped up third to end the first inning.
Third baseman, number eight, Jeff Miller.
Miller back for a second season in a Gulls uniform. 307 on the season in batting average. Face off against Dan Galino here, who checks the runner at second. Two on, two out, the pitch. Fastball is in there at the knees for strike one. Miller's falls behind quickly here. Tying run in scoring position for Newport at second. Galino goes to work, sets, kicks, and deals. On the outside corner, strike two. Umpires tonight's game. John DeGrolamo pulling balls and strikes behind the plate. Kevin Doble, the base umpire. Two away, two runners on for Newport, who trails the game 1-0. Miller at the plate, the 0-2 pitch. Breaking balls up and away. 1-2 the count. Dan Galino trying to get it out of a bit of a jam here. Two runners on with one out. Now two runners on with two outs. Hoping to make it three out right here with the 1-2 pitch. The runner goes. It's a check swing. The throw to third down in time as Miller is rung up for the out that retires the side. A strikeout here for Miller. The Gulls three and a pair of runners. They've left three after three full. Holyoke one, the Gulls nothing on the NECBL Broadcast Network. So we go to the fourth here at Cardinals Field here with the play-by-play, Mike Lord.
Thank you, Nick. Vincent Gutierrez leading off the top of the fourth inning for the Giants, and he takes the first pitch from Lowry. Low and inside for ball one. Gutierrez reached on an error to lead off the second inning and scored on Pat Irvine's ground out. The 0-1 pitch is swung on and the ground ball of Bouchard at second, who fires over to Murphy at first for the out. 4-3 if you're playing baseball bingo at home, and that will bring up the center fielder, Jason Rago, Rako grounded to the first baseman back in the second inning. The Gulls wearing their home uniforms, white pants, white jerseys, blue lettering outlined with orange and blue caps with a gull on the cap. The Giants wearing their road uniforms, gray pants, red shirts, red hats, and white lettering as the first pitch to Rako is taken low and outside for ball one. Beautiful evening here as most of the left field is covered in shadow here at Cardings Field. Here's the 1-0 pitch by Laurie, taken low and outside again, so the count is two balls, no strikes to Jason Rako, who comes into tonight's game batting 162. The right-handed batter out of Fairfield, Connecticut, awaits the 2-0 pitch, and here it comes. Swung on and popped up to the right side and out of play. So the count is two balls and one strikes now to Jason Rako. The Giants is a team batting 221. The Gulls batting 251 as a team. The infield playing back for Rako. Here's the 2-1 pitch swung on. And a high fly ball to right field. Going back is Tim Henry. And this ball is off the fence. Rounding first and in the second with the stand-up double is Jason Rako. And I'll tell you, Nick, that ball, it just seemed like it tailed away at the last second. I thought it was going to hit above the Gulls sign in right center field, and then it curved over and hit the triangular part of the fence.
Well, we're only about a block away from the water here at Cardines Field. Sometimes the ocean sea breeze will get into the ballpark and swirl around. That's what happened there as the wind blew the ball and bounced it off the fence where it juts out there.
So the Giants get a one-out double and they have runner on second. That will bring up the catcher, number 9, Pat Irvine, who grounded home a run back in the second inning. He takes the first pitch from Laurie Lowe for ball one. Irvine coming into the game batting 150. The left-handed batter out of Westwood, Massachusetts, awaits the pitch, and it swung on and foul tipped at the plate. The count is even at 1-1.
Despite allowing only one run so far, Laurie has been a little bit off target here tonight.
Laurie gets the sign from Molicone. The infield playing back, Miller playing on the edge of the infield grass. The 1-1 pitch is swung on. Drive to right field, base hit over the leap of Matt Bouchard. Round in third. The throw from Scott Brown is cut off by the pitcher Laurie, and scoring is Jason Rako from second base. And the Holyoke Giants lead 2-0 as Irvine hit a flare to right over the second baseman's head. Bouchard backpedaled about 10 feet in the outfield grass, made a nice leap. Scott Brown picked up the ball and made a throw home, and Mike Laurie made a nice play, Nick, by cutting off the ball, preventing Irvin from going to second base on the throw. So that will bring up Justin Albert, and he swings and foul tips the first pitch for strike one. So the Giants get a double from Rako, and he's knocked home by Pat Irvin, and he's got two RBIs on the night as the Giants lead the Gulls 2-0 in a very important game here for the Giants. The pitch is taken for a called strike, so the count is two balls and a strike to Justin Albert. The Giants over the next week are heading into the toughest part of their schedule. As the infield playing back, Miller playing even with the bag at third, the 2-1 pitch is taken high and outside, ball three. The Giants come home tomorrow to take on the Mainers in two games up at Keene before the All-Star break, so that's kind of like a long-tailed cat walking through a room full of rocking chairs. As the count is two balls and a strike, and Albert fists the ball foul down the right field line. The count is even at two balls and two strikes. As Jim Murphy holding the runner Irvin on at first base, Miller playing even with the bag at third. The outfield playing fairly deep for Albert. The 2-2 pitch is swung on and popped up towards second base. Bouchard, near the edge of the outfield grass, is under it, and he makes the catch for out number two.
Well, that's exactly what the Gulls wanted there, an easy out. And now, of course, the inning will not potentially be a big one here for the Giants, of course. Two out hits have come a couple of times tonight for Holyoke, so it's not over. The goal's not out of this yet, but a little bit better here for the Newport Gold situationally.
And that will bring up Phil Allen, 2 for 2, a single to left in the first and a single to center in the second inning. And Allen takes the first pitch low and inside for ball one. Allen coming in tonight's game batting 239, so his 2 for 2 performance will raise his average a whisker. As Jeff Miller playing even with the bag at third. Murphy still holding the runner on at first base. The 0-1 pitch is swung on and chopped foul down the first baseline. The count is even at 1-1. I'm Mike Lord with Nick Lima. We're live here in Newport, Rhode Island, where the Giants have a 2-0 lead over the Newport Gulls with 2 outs and 1 on in the top of the 4th inning. And Phil Allen up. Lurie getting the sign from Alicone. The windup, the 1-1 pitch, a swing and a miss at the off-speed pitch for strike two. Nice pitch by Lurie.
And Lurie's off-speed delivery has been right on there all night. He's had a little bit of trouble locating his fastball here and there, but it hasn't really hurt him that much. Just some timely hitting for the Giants. That's been the key of this ball game so far.
The 1-2 pitch, just missing low. That was, I don't know how Phil Allen took that one. That seemed like a strike to me, awfully close to take. But nonetheless, the count is 2 balls and 2 strikes to Allen. Mitchell playing shallow in left and Henry playing medium in center. Here's the 2-2 pitch, taken low for ball three. The count is full. So the crowd not very happy with the home plate umpire over the last two pitches. So the count is full of Phil Allen, runner on first base. Murphy at first still holding the runner on. Miller playing even with the bag at third. Scott Brown playing deep in right field. Strike three called on the payoff pitch was a curveball that caught the low inside part of the plate. And Phil Allen is stunned at the call, but nonetheless, I don't know if that was a makeup call or what, but everything seems to even out in the end. So for the Giants here in the top of the 4th inning, they get 1 run on 2 hits and leave a runner. We're midway through the 4th inning here at historic Cardines Field, and the score: the Holyoke Giants 2, the Newport Gulls nothing. You're listening to this game on the Teamline Sports Network.
Sunday, July 23rd, 2006, is the New England Collegiate Baseball League's All-Star Game at Picturesque Alumni Field in Keene, New Hampshire. Join all 12 NECBL teams, including this year's host, Newport's cross-divisional rival, Keene Swampbats, as well as your 2006 Newport Gulls All-Stars, all 7 of them, for a night of baseball action that can't be missed. For more information on about July 23rd's All-Star Game or the New England Collegiate Baseball League, visit www.necbl.com. That's necbl.com or swampbats.com.
And welcome back to Cardines Field in Newport, Rhode Island. I'm Mike Lord with Nick Lehmer. And as the Gulls come to bat in the bottom of the 4th inning to face Dan Gallino, they trail 2-0. They will send up the 4-5-6 hitters to face Gallino. Murphy leading off. He grounded to third base back in the 2nd inning. He takes the first pitch for a called strike on the outside corner. The count is 0-1 to Murphy, who resides in Kirkland, Washington. The big 6'4", 240-pound right-handed batter takes the 0-1 pitch low and outside as it skips by Pat Irvin for ball one. I'm Mike Lord with Nick Lima, the voice of the Newport Gulls, the best-dressed play-by-play man in the NECBL. As the 1-1 pitch is taken high and inside for ball one, as Nick's got a traditional white shirt, a tie, black pants, and nice dress shoes.
Wingtips.
Yes, much like what Clint Eastwood used to wear in his Dirty Harry films. Oh, the ball is swung on and fouled back, and I flinch. Thank goodness there's a fence, Nick, because I found out that my dental insurance does not cover for teeth broken by foul balls.
That one, if that fence wasn't there, it would have come right back at us.
Ooh. And my reflexes aren't what they used to be. It's the 1-2 pitch is swung on and fouled back.
You forgot to mention my fedora hat, by the way.
Yes, a very nice fedora hat. You're wearing a baseball cap now, the Newport Gulls. And, of course, all the ladies were looking in our direction. Not at me, of course, at Nick.
I don't think my girlfriend will be happy about that one.
Here's the 2-2 pitch. It swung on and popped up the shallow left field. Justin Albert drifting over to his right, and he makes the catch in medium left field for out number one.
Newport Gulls really haven't been able to make some good contact with the ball. They've hit a lot of Adam balls, as Mike Coombs like to say, balls hit right at them. But a double for Malico in the second, an infield hit for Arcadia that he barely got out in the third, and that's all the Gulls have been able to manage along with Tim Henry's walk tonight. And that's why they still trail this ball game 2-0.
And that will bring up the catcher, number 22, John Molicone, who doubled to left field back in the second inning, and he was stranded as he takes the first pitch from Gallino for a called strike on the outside corner. The count is nothing and one. Molicone coming into tonight's game batting 229 as the 0-1 curveball misses low and away for ball one. The count is even to Molicone. The Giants lead it here 2-0 with one out in the bottom of the fourth inning as Molicone swings at the fastball and fouls it off down the third baseline. The count is one ball and two strikes. Scott Brown in the on-deck circle for the Newport Gulls, who come into tonight's game with the best record in the league, 22 wins, 9 losses, the defending NECBL champions. And the Gulls have won 3 titles in 5 years under Chuck Paver's leadership. Here's the 1-2 pitch, just misses outside, so the count is even at 2 balls and 2 strikes. The Gulls, they used to be called the Rhode Island Gulls. Then when Chuck Paver and his group bought the team 5 years ago, they moved it down here to historic Cardinals Field. The 2-2 pitch is swung on, a shallow fly ball to left field. A nice catch by the shortstop, Vincent Gutierrez, who did a nice Willie Mays imitation as he sprinted in the outfield. It made an over-the-shoulder catch about 30 feet in the left field grass for out number 2.
What a play by Gutierrez, who really had to trail that ball down and was sprinting out there, ranging very far out, and made an over-the-shoulder catch out there, still on the run.
Gutierrez has been outstanding for the Giants this season. That will bring up Scott Brown. Brown swings at the first pitch, lines at the right field, but Mike Lyon taking a couple of steps over to his left, position perfectly, makes the catch for out number 3. So that is the second time the Gulls have gone down in order, and we've completed 4 innings here at Cardinals Field. And the score, the Holyoke Giants 2, the Newport Gulls nothing. You're listening to this game on the Team Line Sports Network.
So back here now at Cardinals Field in Newport, Rhode Island, we go to the fifth. Out of town score to report as the Manchester Silkworms lead the Pittsfield Dukes 5-0 up there in Pittsfield. You just heard Marino hit a triple. You're listening on our live internet broadcast. Here once again, the play-by-play, Mike Lord.
Thank you, Nick. As we go to the top of the fifth inning, the Holyoke Giants lead the defending NECBL champion Newport Gulls 2-0. The Giants will send the 2-3-4 hitters to face Mike Lurie. Billy Mottram leading it off for the Giants here in the top of the fifth inning. He's 1-for-2, singled to center in the first and grounded to second in the fourth inning. The first pitch curveball catches the outside corner for a called strike. The count is nothing and one to Mottram as the lights are coming on here at Cardinals Field. Lurie working quickly, fires the 0-1 pitch. Looked like a sinker that Mottram swung at and missed for strike 2.
Talk about that game of Manchester and Pittsfield. They're playing for that fourth playoff spot right now. Manchester 2 games ahead of the Dukes.
Here's the 0-2 pitch by Lurie. Mottram swings, hits a long fly ball to left field. Mitchell drifting back and makes the catch on the edge of the warning track near the left field foul pole for out number 1. So long fly ball out for Billy Mottram. And with one out, that'll bring up the third baseman, number 24, Brian Adamski. Adamski is 0-for-2. He struck out swinging in the first inning and flew out the center back in the third inning. So Adamski out of South Deerfield, Massachusetts, steps up to the plate coming into tonight's game batting 220. The infield playing back for Adamski is the first pitch from Lurie. Curveball taken at the belt for a called strike. The count is nothing and one to Adamski. As the outfield all play in media, Mitchell, Henry, and Brown. The 0-1 pitch is taken for a called strike at the knees. No balls and 2 strikes to Adamski. The Giants got a run in the second and the fourth inning, and that's where we stand, 2-0. Lurie gets the sign from Molicone. The 0-2 pitch swung on, drive to the gap in left field. Mitchell going back, and it's high off the fence. Adamski going in the second with the stand-up double. And Nick, I think that ball landed in the same spot as the double by John Mollicone hit right in front of the old brown house about 5 or 10 feet up on the left center field fence.
And that's a good spot to hit it for the Gulls because in every other spot in left field, the fence is about 11 feet high. That one spot for about a 10-foot stretch is almost about 21 feet high. And that was very helpful for the Gulls as it landed off of that spot and bounced in for a double and stayed inside the park.
Well, here at Cardines Field, the dimension's very unique. There are a couple of triangles in right field. 320 down the right field line goes out to about 345 in left center. A row of houses behind the left center field fence, and that's why I think they heighten the fence to 21 feet. The houses are directly behind the fence. And the playground behind the left field line is stepping up to bat is the right fielder, Mike Lyon. And Lyon swings at the first pitch and hits a drive to right field. Going back is Scott Brown. He makes the catch for the out, and Adamski tagged and bluffed running the third as Scott Brown made a very strong throw to Jeff Miller at third base. So we have two outs, and Adamski remains at second base. That will bring up the first baseman, number 11, Thomas Hill.
And here already in the fifth inning, this game moving on very quickly, but the lights come on here at Cardines Field.
Yes, a fast-moving game. Bad news for concession stands. Thomas Hill stepping up the bat. He's 0-2. Fielder's choice in the first inning. Struck out swinging in the third inning as he takes Larray's pitch outside for ball one. Hill coming into tonight's game batting 219, second on the team in RBIs, as the fans are still filing in here to Cardines Field. The 1-0 pitch is swung on in a high pop-up to right field, and under it is Scott Brown, and he makes the catch for out number three. So that'll do it for the Giants in the top of the fifth inning. They get no runs on one hit and leave a runner. We're midway through the fifth inning here at historic Cardines Field. And the score, the Holyoke Giants 2, the Newport Gulls nothing. You're listening to this game on the Team Line Sports Network. And welcome back to Cardines Field as we go to the bottom of the fifth inning. I'm Mike Lord with Nick Lima, and Chris Dominguez takes the first pitch from Dan Galeno for a called strike. And the second pitch is also a called strike, so Dominguez finds himself. It's 1-1, I stand corrected. Here's the 1-1 pitch by Galeno. Just misses outside for ball two, so the count is 2-1 to Dominguez, who grounded the third back in the second inning. Dominguez comes into the game batting 186, which is the lowest average among the Gulf starters. The 2-1 pitch is taken for a called strike two. Crowd not liking the call. Galeno getting the sign from Irvin, the infield playing back. The curveball is swung on and popped foul over our head, so the count remains at 2 balls and 2 strikes. We're in the bottom of the fifth inning. The Holyoke Giants lead the Newport Gulls 2-0 in a very important game for the Gulls as they're trying to cement a playoff spot. The 2-2 pitch by Galeno as Dominguez got a late swing on it and grounded it down the third baseline foul.
And things are looking better and better for Newport despite trailing this game so far. Beating North Adams last night, shutting them out 4-0, put them 4.5 games up on the Steeplecats for first place.
The infield playing back, the 2-2 pitch, and Dominguez swings and misses at the off-speed pitch for strike three. So that is strikeout number two for Dan Galeno so far, and that will bring up the left fielder number 17, Brian Mitzel. Yeah, the way the Gulls are playing, they're 5 games ahead of second place North Adams in the loss column. I think the theme song for the Gulls should be Runaway.
I don't think we've gone over the defensive alignment yet for the Giants.
I'll go over it after this pitch. As checking his swing and taking it for a called strike is Brian Mitzel. Count, there's no balls and one strike. Thomas Hill at second. At first, Billy Motram at second. Vincent Gutierrez at short. Adamski at third. As swinging at the 0-1 pitch and grounding it foul down the third baseline is Brian Mitzel. He's behind in the count, no balls and two strikes. Adamski at third. Irvin behind the plate. The outfield tonight, Albert in left, Rago in center, Lyon in right. Galeno gets to sign the 0-2 pitch, swung on to miss strike three. And Nick, I think Mitchell may have swung at a throwaway ball one pitch.
Back-to-back strikeouts here for Galeno, and the Gulls have to be a little bit more patient at the plate if they aren't get to Galeno here, as his pitch count isn't all that high at this point. He's really been mowing down the Gulls.
No, it isn't. As a matter of fact, in the first inning, the Gulls, all three outs were the flyout route. So that'll bring up Ryan Arcadia, who takes the first pitch at the knees for called strike. The count is nothing and one. Arcadia had an infield single back in the third inning. As Galeno gets a sign from Irvin, the 0-1 pitch misses low and outside for ball one. Arcadia coming into tonight's game from 297. Plays his college ball at Villanova. Awaits the 1-1 pitch from Galeno. Just misses low for ball two. And Arcadia resides in Saddle River, New Jersey. Sounds like an old Western town. As Galeno fires the 2-1 pitch and it's swung on, a slow ground to the third. Adamski has it, pumps, fires to Hill at first for the out. So a second consecutive 1-2-3 inning for Galeno, and he has now retired 8 consecutive Gulls. We've completed 5 innings here at Cardines Field in Newport, Rhode Island, and the score remains the Holyoke Giants 2, the Newport Gulls 1. You're listening to this game on the Teamline Sports Network. And welcome back to historic Cardines Field. I'm Mike Lord with the dapper Nick Lemer, and coming up to bat for the Giants in the top of the sixth inning, Gutierrez, Rago, and Irvin to face Mike Lurie. And taking the first pitch for a called strike is Gutierrez, who reached on an error in the second inning and grounded the second back in the fourth inning. The 0-1 pitch misses low, so the count is even at 1-1. The Giants lead the Gulls 2-0. Only one of the runs were earned as Gutierrez reached on an error and subsequently scored on the ground out by Pat Irvine, as the 1-1 pitch misses low for ball two. So Gutierrez coming into tonight's game batting 222, made an outstanding defensive gem back in the third inning for the Giants. As the 2-1 pitch is swung on and fouled back, so the count is 2-2. The Giants coming into tonight's game at 14-17, tied with the Keene Swamp Bats for third place in the NECBL North Division. The infield playing back, the 2-2 pitch is swung on and grounded foul in the first base dugout, so the count remains at 2-2. Most of the field is covered in shadow here except the right field fence. And there's a concrete building with the scoreboard in right field foul territory. The pitch, a curveball, is swung on and grounded through the hole on the right side for a base hit. So for the third time tonight, the Giants get the leadoff batter on, and that will bring up the center fielder, number 18, Jason Rago. Rago grounded the first back in the second inning and doubled in the fourth inning. So the Giants trying to get some insurance runs here, because the Gulls offense is capable of lighting up the scoreboard faster than Macy's can light up their Christmas tree. Rago, the right-handed batter, stepping up to the plate, and he swings at the first pitch and hits a fly ball to right field. Coming in a few steps is Scott Brown and makes the catch for out number one. And Vincent Gutierrez retreats to first base. One out here in the top of the sixth inning, runner on first base for the Giants. That will bring up the catcher, number 9, Pat Irvine. Or should I say Irvin, I'm sorry. Irvin has accounted for knocking in both Giant runs. He knocked home Gutierrez from third base with the ground out the second, and he knocked home Rago from second base with a single to right field. So Irvin's had himself his best offensive showing this season for the Giants. Quick throw over to first base, and diving back safely is Gutierrez. Jim Murphy holding the runner on at first base. Miller playing even with the bag at third. The outfield playing deep for Irvin. Irvin swings and hits a drive to the gap in left field. But going over and making the catch is Brian Mitchell, as he ran over to his left, covered quite a bit of ground, and was able to make the catch for out number two. And Nick, if that ball had gotten by Mitchell, Gutierrez would have easily scored from first base with this speed.
Yeah, that could have been a lot of trouble here. That could have put the Gulls down 3-0. Instead, it's a loud second out for the Giants.
And that will bring up Justin Albert. Albert is 1-for-2. Albert takes the first pitch low in the dirt, and Molicone temporarily drops the ball, but the runner Gutierrez does not advance. Albert was brilliant in relief against the Concord Quarry Dogs back on Monday night. 5 innings of scoreless relief. Gutierrez taking about a 2-step lead. The pitch is taken for a called strike, so the count is even at 1-1 to Justin Albert, who comes into tonight's game batting .097. Albert, the Hull native, left-handed batter, steps back in, swings and hits a one-hopper back to the Mike Lurie, who runs over and underhands the ball this time to Jim Murphy for the final out. So 1-3 if you're playing baseball bingo at home, and that'll do it for the Giants in the top half of the sixth inning. They get no runs on one hit and leave a runner. We're midway through the sixth inning here at historic Cardines Field, and the score, the Holyoke Giants 2, the Newport Gulls nothing. You're listening to this game on the Team Line Sports Network. And welcome back to historic Cardines Field in Newport, Rhode Island. I'm Mike Lord with Nick Lemer as the Gulls go to bat in the bottom sixth inning, trailing the Giants 2-0. Tim Henry takes the first pitch from Dan Gallino for a called strike at the knees. Henry is 0-for-1 tonight, flew out in the first inning and walked in the third as the 0-1 pitch misses low for ball one. The count is even to Tim Henry. 2 runs, 8 hits, and no errors for the Giants, as the 1-1 pitch is taken low and inside for ball two. So the Newport Gulls trying to find a rhythm here. They've got 2 hits so far, but it was 2 costly errors that have given the Giants a 2-0 lead. Here's Gallino with the 2-1 pitch, swung on to miss for strike two, so the count is even to Tim Henry. Henry coming into tonight's game batting .306. Adamski playing even with the bag at third, the rest of the infield playing on the edge of the outfield grass. The 2-2 pitch is swung on in a high chopper to the right side. Motram has it, fires over to Hill at first for the out. Nice play by Billy Motram, as it was a high chopper over the pitcher's head, and Motram got the ball with his momentum carrying him away from first base, turned around and still made a nice throw to Thomas Hill for out number one. So that will bring up the second baseman, number 3, Matt Bouchard, who's 0-for-2. He flew out twice, once to center and once to right field. Bouchard coming into tonight's game batting .284. Plays his college ball at Georgetown, awaits the first pitch from Gallino, and here it comes. The fastball misses low for ball one. The count is 1-0 to Bouchard. I'm Mike Lode with Nick Lemer. Glad you could join us here in historic Cardines Field. The Giants have one of the biggest upsets of the evening, a 2-0 lead. As swinging at the 0-1 pitch is Bouchard, and hits it through the hole in left field for a base hit. That's only the third hit of the evening for the Gulls, and that will bring up the third baseman, number 8, Jeff Miller.
That brings the tying run to the plate here for Newport for the first time in a while. The Gulls have their first base runner since the third.
And Miller is 0-for-2. He popped out the third back in the first inning and struck out swinging in the third inning. So the Giant infield in a double play depth as Jeff Miller steps up the bat, looking over to third base, getting signals from the coach at third.
Greg Grawl over there.
Very nice crowd here at Cardines Field. Snap throw over to first, and nice play by Thomas Hill as he had to reach up for that ball. The Giants have to be careful here, Nick, because they've been victimized by too many errant pickoff throws.
And with a close game like this, you have to be careful not to get the crowd too into it, as well as that will affect the Newport Gulls offense as well.
Dan Gallino in one of his finest outings of the season so far for the Giants. Gallino getting the sign from Irvine. The right-handed batter Miller awaits the pitch, and here it comes. The fastball just misses outside for ball one, as Pat Irvin, the catcher, tried to frame that pitch to no avail. Runner on first for the Gulls. One out here in the bottom of the sixth inning. They trail the Giants 2-0. The Giants infield is in a double play depth. Galeno getting the sign, the right-handed pitcher fires and swinging and hitting it down the right field line. Foul on the roof of the
warehouse.
Building and of the warehouse in foul territory is Jeff Miller. So the count is one ball and one strike. And that was a very well hit ball as it easily cleared the building and landed about halfway back on the roof. Bouchard taking the lead at first, being held on at Thomas Hill, the first baseman. The rest of the infield in at double play depth. The 1-1 pitch, ground ball to Gutierrez. Flips him on, trim the one, the throw to first, double play! So the Giants get a big break on more outstanding fielding by Vinny Gutierrez as he turned over a 6-4-3 double play. And that'll do it for the Gulls in the bottom of the sixth inning. We've completed six innings here as the Gulls get no runs on one hit and nobody left. And the score at the end of six innings, the Holyoke Giants 2, the Newport Gulls nothing. You're listening to this game on the Teamline Sports Network. Welcome back to historic Hardings Field. I'm Mike Lorden as the Holyoke Giants come to bat in the top of the seventh inning against Mike Larray. They will send up the top of the order. And to take you through the play-by-play the next three innings, the charismatic voice of the Newport Gulls, Nick Lima.
Thank you once again, Mike. Nick Lima alongside Mike Lord here on the NECAL Broadcast Network as the Newport Gulls have trailed this one all the way along. 2-0 the score here in the seventh. It'll be Phil Allen, who's 2-for-3 tonight, a pair of singles and a strikeout against Larry to lead things off for the Holyoke Giants. Interleague play here at Cardines, Northern Division versus the Southern Division. We'll be seeing a lot of interleague play on Sunday as the All-Star teams meet up at Keene for the NECBL All-Star game. The Gulls will be sending 7 players to the game along with their coaching staff and Chris Dominguez to the home run derby. Phil Allen steps up from the left side, batting for the fourth time tonight. He is 2-for-3. Larry ready. The pitch. Squares for a bunt and butts it foul up the third base line. A surprise bunt there in the first pitch from Allen.
Phil Allen has got 7 bunt singles so far for the Giants this year. Every time he steps up to bat, the opposing third baseman always plays in on the edge of the infield grass.
Nothing and one the count on Allen. Billy Martram waits on deck. He'll be followed by Brian Ademski. Top of the order is due up here for the Giants. Looking to add to their lead as the pitch comes in. Swinging and a miss. Strike 2. However, opposing teams have only scored 1 run this season off the Gulls in the seventh all season long. Same thing in the ninth, the 0-2. Up and away, ball 1. Newport Gulls relief pitching responsible for that, which has been stellar all season long. However, the starter, Larry, still out there. Here comes the pitch. It swung on, hit in the air to center field. This one's well hit, but out there is Henry to take it for the inning's first out.
The Giants had a big problem with relief pitching in the first, 15 games as they let a lot of leads slip away, but their relief pitching in the last 10 games has been very strong.
The Gulls have never lost a game when they are leading after 6 this season. However, despite them being 15-0 when leading at the 6, that doesn't matter here because they're trailing by 2, and the Giants looking to add more here with 1 out. The pitch to Martram, fouled to the left. Billy, 1-for-3, a single back in the first, stranded on base then. He bounced the second to end the second inning and flew out to left to lead off the fifth. He's batting here with 1 out in the seventh. The pitch. Swinging a line shot. Fair ball right side. And Montrum is on with his second hit of the night. He's going to hold up at first as the ball is recovered out there by Scott Brown.
Nice piece of hitting by Billy Martram. The ball took off and must have had a lot of topspin on it because it just dropped like a dying quail once it went over Matt Bouchard's head.
So a runner at first here and just 1 out. How did the order do up here for the Giants? Brian Ademski He's 1-for-3, a double his last time, struck out in the first. One of four strikeout victims of Lurie. And here comes Scott Virgilak out to the mound. The Newport Gulls will get some action in their bullpen here as the heart of the order comes up. And there's a runner on first. Let's see if our camera operators can get a shot inside of that bullpen and see who's warming up for us. We don't have a good view here from where we sit. We have to rely on our left field cameraman, Tim Wine, out there.
Well, the next two batters for the Giants are right-handed batters, so it'll be interesting.
And it looks like the Gulls will get left-handed action up. We're watching on our live video cast. You'll be able to see for the Newport Gulls. Left-handed pitcher throwing, number 15, Blake Hamilton, is warming up in the bullpen for the Gulls, who have double, and also something up for Holyoke as well. The pitch is outside and low.
Yeah, Blake Hamilton played the two prior seasons with the Holyoke Giants. I had a chance to meet him and his family on many occasions. Wonderful people. Blake is a good student at Cornell University.
Tyler Storr warming up for Holyoke here in the seventh. The 1-0 skips in there, ball two. So each team getting just-in-case relief action up in their bullpen here. So we are late in this ball game. 2-0, Holyoke on top of the Gulls. The Giants have had some success here at Cardinals Field. Neely team had success last year as the 1-0 pitch is taken on the inside corner, strike one. The game last season at Cardinals Field between these two teams was power outaged out. They're just about ready to get underway. But a cable was snapped, an underwater cable leading here to Quinnick Island. And the 1-1 pitch, swinging a high fly ball, well hit left field, way back, this one goes. This ball will be off the top of the wall. Hitting third is Majram. He's going to score the throw. Not in time, here comes the throw into third. It is in time as off the bag is Ademski. He's retired at third, but he gets the job done with an RBI double, scoring Marsham, and the Giants lead it 3-0.
Brian Ademski with great speed may have been a little too aggressive on the base paths, but that was the hardest hit ball I've seen him hit in a long time. Ademski had a knee injury early in the season. He was ripping the cover off the ball, and that pitch, like you said, Nick, the fence is about 21 feet high. That ball hit about 19 and a half feet up on that fence off one of the signs next to Subway.
Look, the auto center sign up there, about 16, 17 feet up the fence, the pitch. Swinging a missed strike one to line, so the Giants now lead it 3-0. It was back-to-back hits here for Holyoke off of Lurie, who's still in the game, pitching to line, the cleanup hitter. But the base is empty. Line is 0-for-3. Reacher on error. The pitch. Swinging a miss. Strike two. Reacher on error by the pitcher in the third. It's later caught stealing. Lurie had a casually overhand toss to first for a ground out, but his toss did not make it to the bag as this one gets away from Malacone for ball one.
So Malacone's played a very good game. He threw out a giant base stealer, and then, even though he didn't tag Martram, made a very nice throw to Jeff Miller to get Ademski trying to stretch a double into a triple.
The 1-2, swing and a miss, strike three. Lion fans for the second time tonight. However, the Holyoke Giants tag Lurie for two more hits, including the RBI double by Ademski, who was thrown out at third. And as we go to the seventh inning stretch time, the Giants 3, the Gulls nothing. Let's pick up Gulls public address announcer Don O'Hanley for taking me out to the ball game.
Are you ready? Take me out to the ball game. Take me out to the crowd. I need some meatballs and crackers.
Seventh inning stretch time here at Cardinals Field. Holyoke 3, Newport nothing on the NECBL Broadcast Network.
Attention, Gulls fans.
as we go to the seventh inning here at Cardinals Field in Newport, Rhode Island. This will be a Tigers TV crew power inning. Any Newport Gold batter to hit a home run in this inning will receive a free video copy of today's broadcast, courtesy of the Tigers TV crew on DVD. Tigers TV crew is proud to bring you Newport Gold's baseball here on the NACBO Broadcast Network. Ball one to Jim Murphy. The Gold's trail 3-0. The next pitch is missing low, ball two. And out there for another inning of work, Dan Galeano. Galito, ready? A 2-0 pitch. Low and inside, ball three, and Murphy maybe reaching base for the first time tonight. The power hitter has 6 home runs in the season, leads the league in RBIs, 0 for 2 tonight, the 3-0. In there for a strike on the inside corner.
Yeah, I think Murphy had the takes on, sign on all the way on the 3-0 count.
Hitter's count now, the pitch. Swing and a miss, strike two, and from 3-0, he's worked the count back up to 3-2. Jim Murphy, batting .330, leads the team in average, leads the league in RBIs with 28. 6 home runs in the season, tied with his teammate Chris Dominguez, along with Twisters Matt Arbor and Andres Perez. The payoff pitch, swinging a grounder, fair ball right side, and the Gulls will have a leadoff single here to work with in the first as Murphy sends a little ground ball into the gap and right for a base hit. Here comes John Moncone, who had the double, the Gulls' first base runner and first hit back in the second inning. There's Strindon on base. The Gulls have left only 3 on tonight because they've only gotten 3 on base prior to Murphy's single. The Gulls have actually had 4 on base prior to the single. They had 3 hits and a walk. Galano's pitch is in there for a strike to Moncone, who is 1-for-2. Fly out to the shortstop on an outstanding play made by Gutierrez back in the fourth. Galino comes to the set. The 0-1. Breaking ball's in there for strike two. Moncone, any CBL veteran, played for the Danbury Westerners last year, and is now a 2-time All-Star. Joining his teammate Jim Murphy, who stands in at first as it takes the next pitch outside, ball one in the dirt. Good stop by the catcher, Irvin.
Irvin doing a stellar job behind the plate for the Giants in the last 20 games. He got off to a very slow start, but he's really come on defensively.
Scott Brown waits on deck. The 1-2 pitch to Moncone. Breaking ball just missing the outside corner. And count even at 2-2. The Gulls need base runners here. They have a runner at first, Murphy, but trail this ball game 3-0. Every out from this point out is going to count very strongly. From the set, Galino, his pitch. Fastball missing inside, ball three. And all of a sudden, it's a full count on Moncone. Brown takes a practice swing on deck. Dominguez after him. Some real power coming up for Newport as Moncone taps the plate. Looking in for the sign and now throwing into first. Diving in safely is Murphy. Galino trying to pick off Jim there. He's almost caught surprise. Moncone, .229 average, 2 homers, 9 runs batted in. Has a pair of homers here at Cardinals Field. The payoff pitch. Ball four is outside, and the tying run comes to the plate for the first time in a long time as Scott Brown steps up. Brown 0-for-2 tonight, represents the tying run for Newport, and Galino may be tiring a little bit here.
Yeah, his pitches were a little low and outside now, and he was lucky that he got Moncone the swing on a couple of pitches there.
An infield conference out there on the mound as Joel Southern has a few words with Galino. No word yet of whether or not he's going to make a call to the bullpen, as there is action ready for both teams out there. You saw them warming up in the top of the seventh. We're here in the bottom of the seventh at Cardinals Field in Newport. 3-0 Giants, but the goal is threatening. They have runners at first and second. Nobody out. Scott Brown due up. Chris Dominguez to follow. Each of those batters 0-for-2 tonight. Matter of fact, the entire bottom part of the lineup is 1-for-8. Arcadia, the only one to reach base tonight. Top pot hasn't done all that well either. four for 16 with a walk for the first six in the line. Four for 15 with a walk is the first five in the lineup tonight. Very easy to read this scorecard as the Gulls haven't been able to get much going. They have something going here in the seventh. Two on the pitch. Brown squares for a bunt, takes the ball outside. Some seagulls fly out over the playground in left field. Brown eyes that left field fence. He's hit a home run over there before. Has three in the season. Second season in a Newport Gulls uniform. The URI outfielder stands ready. The 1-0 pitch. Pulls the bat away as squaring for a bunt. Taking another pitch low, ball two. A walk here would bring real power and Dominguez up. A pair of all-stars stand on base, Murphy and Marlicone. From the set, Galino, a 2-0 delivery to the plate. Missing low and away, ball three. Brown showing bunt again. Dan Galino gets the sign from Irvin. Ready. He sets. Kicks and delivers. On the outside corner, taken for a strike. Brown, for the first time, did not show bunt. Waiting for a pitch he could hammer. It was a little bit outside of his reach. Scott grounded out to second, flew out to right. Like to get a hit here for Newport. Here's the tying run, the delivery, swing and a pop up. Left side giving chase is the third baseman, Ademski. He's gonna watch this one land just foul up the third base line, and sliding for it was the shortstop Gutierrez. He couldn't get it as he slid into the stopper over there.
Yeah, Ademski was spun around at third base. He was running towards fair territory. Then the ball drifted foul and he completely turned around and seemed to lose sight of it. And Gutierrez, making an outstanding effort from the shortstop position, was able to catch up to it, but unfortunately couldn't hold on.
There's only about 15 feet of foul territory, the third base bag. That narrows as the diagonal continues down the line to about 8 feet right at the bullpen. 3-2 the count on Scott Brown, two on, nobody out. The pitch from Galito, here it is. Swinging a hard ground ball chopper over the second baseman, five second out there on a first, on to third. Not in time. He didn't throw to first. He threw to third to try and double off Murphy. And the Newport Gulls have runners at the corners here. He had a chance to get Brown at first. I did not see him throw to first with a double play. That only puts one out on the board, as easily into third is Jim Murphy.
Yeah, at least the Giants got one out here, but still they didn't get the lead runner. And I don't think they would have got the double play if they tried for first base, because Scott Brown got down the line pretty quickly. I think he was about a step ahead of his shadow.
So erased is Marlicone. Runners at the corners, Murphy at third, Brown at first. Chris Dominguez to bat here. Six homers on the season will represent the Gulls in the Home Run Derby up in Keene on Sunday afternoon. That will be broadcast live on the NCBO Broadcast Network. The pitch, swing and a miss, strike one. That's around 4:15, 4:30. If you want to listen to that, you should tune up the Keene All-Star Game for the NCBL, as all 12 teams sending players up there. Invite everyone to listen in all evening up in Keene on Sunday afternoon. The 0-1. Swing and a miss, strike two. Dominguez strikes out an awful lot, but has a lot of power. A lot of pop in his bat, just trying to get some little bit more patience at the plate.
Both pitches were nice fastballs by Galino inside that Dominguez swung on. Let's see if Galino goes outside here.
The 0-2 pitch. Swing and a miss, strike three. Came inside the fastball, and Dominguez fans on three pitches. Out, strikeout for the second time tonight, and that's the fourth strikeout for Galino. Now there are two outs, and the Gulls could be wasting a two-on-nobody-out situation here as Brian Mitzel comes up to the plate. They may not get another chance like this. They'll be at the Mitzel's 0-2, a strikeout, a ground out. The bat here, runners at the corners. Mitzel's a tying run. Go-ahead run is still in the on-deck circle for Newport. Galino comes to the set. The pitch, swing and a miss, strike one. Beautiful sunset out towards the west here at Cardines as shades of purple and orange dot the sky. If you're watching on a live video feed, you can see that. Galeno sees the glove of his catcher, Irvin, as the next pitch is in there for ball one.
The first two pitches Galeno threw to Mitchell were outside. The three pitches to Dominguez that struck him out were all inside. So Galeno changing his locations.
He comes set high, the 1-1. Swing and a miss, strike two. Mitchell chased a curve that came inside. 1-2 the count on Brian, and Galeno about to get it out of this inning unless Mitchell can stay alive here. One ball, two strikes to count. Murphy a lead at third, Brown a lead at first. 3-0 Holyoke. From the set, Galeno, the pitch. Check swing, it's taken for a foul ball up the first base line. He checked the swing and followed up the first base line. We couldn't see it, but it's a foul ball, and Mitchell barely stays alive. He'll do it again. Dan Galeno checks the runner from the stretch. The 1-2. Swinging a ground ball, chop foul around the plate area. Mitchell, a defensive swing there, stays alive. Home plate umpire, John DeGolamo, dusts off the plate. Kevin Noble, the base umpire tonight. ACAC umpiring crew for the ball game. Runners at the corners, two down. The Gulls trail at 3-0 here in the seventh. The 1-2 pitch. Check swing, did he go? No, says Noble. And it's ball two. Count evens up on Mitchell. He barely stayed alive there as Mitchell barely checked the swing, and the pitch was just out of the strike zone. Sun continues to set, a beautiful sunset here on a beautiful night as checking Brown at first is Galeno diving in safely. Good crowd here to witness this game, but the Gulls have been lacking offense in it. Also made a costly error, one of two errors on the night for Newport. They're batting here, the 2-2. Outside in the dirt, ball three, blocked by Irvin. And Mitchell is battling. He is battling here with Galeno, and the Gulls need every bit of this battle. Ryan Arcadia waits on deck. Brian Mitchell, ready. They're at the corners. They lead the 3-2 pitch. Swing and a high pop up right side. Out there is Ryan. He will make the catch for the out that retires the side. The Newport goes three and a pair of runners. They've left five. And after a 7 full, Holyoke 3, Newport nothing on the NECBL Broadcast Network. Hey Gulls fans, want to know more about the Newport Gulls? Log on to www.newportgulls.com today and get all the latest stats and standings. Follow your favorite players all season long or find out about the latest giveaways, promotions, and special events. For game day, organizational, and other information, visit NewportGulls.com or call 401-849-4982. That's 401-849-4982. The Newport Gulls are a 501c3 nonprofit organization. New pitcher out there on the mound for the Newport Gulls will be Blake Hamilton. As we go to the top of the eighth, the Holyoke Giants lead this ball game 3-0. The first pitch from Hamilton is missing inside, ball one to Thomas Hill. Hill on the night, 0-for-3, a ground out, a fly out, a strikeout. Has been retired three times to end an inning. Leads off the eighth here, swings and misses the next pitch, strike one. 1-1 the count on Thomas. Vincent Gutierrez due up next, then Jason Rago. Hamilton, a lefty, ready. The 1-1, swing and a miss, strike two. Well, Hamilton replaces Mike Lurie while working a line on him. Hamilton. Cornell University, San Antonio, Texas. The pitch, up and away. And the count even at two balls, two strikes to Thomas from Blake. Hamilton working quickly. The pitch, swing, a high pop up left side, charging on the left fielder, Mitchell. And the shortstop out there, Ryan Arcadia, ranging out there, makes a catch in front of Mitchell for the inning's first out.
Outstanding catch by Arcadia, much like Gutierrez back in the fourth inning. And the Giants dodged quite a bullet there in the bottom of the seventh inning. I figured it'd be easier to get out of Fort Knox with a bar of gold than for the Giants to get out of the inning without giving up any runs.
Here comes Gutierrez, the first pitch to him. Up and inside ball one. I wouldn't say that. I was stationed at Fort Knox a couple years ago. It is not easy at all to get out of there with a bar of gold, let me tell you. I can't tell you firsthand, but let me tell you. The 1-0. Inside low, a fastball ball to Hamilton on the season for the Gulls. A 9.28 ERA, 0-2 in five appearances, made two starts. This is his seventh appearance this season, or sixth appearance this season. The pitch, swinging a foul back, strike one. 2-1 the count here on Gutierrez, who's one for three. Reach on error. Scored the first run of the ball game. Singled, bounced to second. A pitch. Strike call in the outside corner, Hamilton. Pitched 10 and two-thirds innings, gave up 19 hits, 13 runs, 11 of them earned, has walked 7, struck out 12. Gave up two doubles, a triple, no homers. Thrown a pair of wild pitches and hit a pair of batters. As this one is missing, ball three, a full count here to Vincent Gutierrez. Did single his last time up. He's led off three innings, bats here with one out, the base is empty, the payoff pitch. Outside ball four. He reaches base for the third time tonight. So Gutierrez walks on a 3-2. And now bring up Jason Rago. A double, a flyout, a ground out on the night. One for three. Marlicone steps out, gives signs to the infield here. The runner at first, one out. The Gulls trying to stay in this one. We're in the eighth. And Newport has been shut out all along. 3-0 the score. Hamilton comes set, the belt, the lefty throws, a fastball is in there for a strike, nothing in one. Rago grounded out to first, double in the fourth, and scored. Second run of the day for Holyoke. Their third run came just now in the seventh. The 0-1, swinging a line shot, right field, a base hit. Holding at second base will be Gutierrez and Jason Rago. Lines a single off of Blake Hamilton here into right field, and the Giants threaten again here in the eighth. Two on with one out.
Giants need to capitalize here. They need to put together a string of at least three or four hits here to give some breathing room to Galeno, although I don't think he's going to be pitching in the eighth inning. He seemed to be tiring a little bit. I think Coach Joel Southern may be going to the relief staff here.
And speaking of relief staff, Larry, who pitched the first seven innings of this ball game, was relieved by Hamilton here. Got the first out, has walked the batter to give up a single. And Mike Coombs out here to talk with Hamilton. He's just come into this ball game in relief of Larry. Larry gave up 9 hits. Of the 3 runs given up, 2 of them were earned. Larry hit hard a couple times, gave up 3 doubles. And he stands to get the loss in this game. Pitched 7 complete innings, did strike out 5 on the night. A full infield conference now will be broke up by home plate umpire John DeGolamo. As Coombs still talking things over with Hamilton as he backpedals to the dugout. Runners at first and second for the Holyoke Giants. The Gulls trying to stay in this game here in the eighth inning. Pat Irvin is 1 for 3, an RBI single in the fourth. Full out to left in the sixth. Back in the second inning, he bounced out to second. One away, Hamilton with the pitch. Fastball's in there for strike one. Hamilton, a left-handed pitcher, up against a left-handed batter. And catcher for the Giants, Patrick Irvin. He comes set the belt. The 0-1. Outside, ball one. Hamilton, ready? A 1-1 pitch, he has to be careful with Irvin. It's missing low and away. Left-handed batters hitting 438 off of Blake Hamilton. 7 for 16 coming into the game tonight with lefties against Blake, who works here. The runners at first and second. He sets, kicks, delivers. High and outside, ball three.
I talked to Blake Hamilton before the game, and he said he struggled at Cornell this season, and unfortunately for the young man, his struggling has continued here with Newport.
A walk here with load the bases, the 3-1 pitch. Ball four is inside. Now load him up for Justin Albert. Oh, walking on a 3-1 pitch is Irvin, and Albert steps up to the plate, 1-for-3. The Giants here with one out are in danger of blowing this one open as the Gulls struggle to keep up here. We're in the eighth, 3-0 Holyoke. Now only the second meeting between these two teams this season. The Gulls taking the first one, 3-0, or 5-0 a few weeks back. The pitch. Fastball on the outside corner, strike one. Justin Albert, single in the second. Popped up to the second baseman in the fourth. Grounded out to the pitcher in the sixth. Lurie stands to get the loss in this game. Hamilton out here, the pitch to the eighth. In relief of Lurie, pitched 7 strong innings, giving up 2 earned runs, 3 overall. The delivery, swing and a miss. A big cut from Albert, another lefty. Batting here against the left-hander Hamilton. And he's in a hole though, nothing in two. Bases are loaded, one out. Hamilton comes set to the belt. The 0-2 pitch, foul tip to the left side, a defensive swing there from Albert. That last checkup in Pittsfield, Mass, the Dukes falling to the Silkworm 6-0. Haven't heard any other updates from there as of yet. The 0-2. High and inside, ball one. Nowhere to put Albert here. One out. A Holyoke Giant on every single base. Hamilton comes to the set. The 1-2 delivery. Swing and a miss, strike three. A huge strikeout for Hamilton. A pair of walks and a single issued by him, all back to back. Loaded the bases for Albert, who fans, and will go back to the top of the order. Phil Allen, 2-for-4. Single in the first and second. Stranded on base both times. Allen struck out looking to end the fourth and flew out to center to lead off the seventh inning. He'll bat here with the bases loaded and 2 away. Allen takes the first pitch, a fastball low and outside for ball one. With the bases loaded, Allen is 1-for-6.
Yeah, Giants lead the league in strikeouts.
Just 167 with the bases jammed. The 1-0. Strike called on the inside. Allen disagreed, and the count will be 1-1 to him. Hamilton trying to get out of this inning. The bases are loaded. 2 outs. The 1-1 pitch. Swing and a miss. Strike 2. Gutierrez, who walked at third. Rago, single at second. Irvin, who walked at first. At the plate, Allen, the 1-2 pitch, just missing a fastball on the outside corner, and they will even up at 2-2 on Allen. Blake Hamilton gets the signs from Molicone. He winds, kicks, and delivers. Strike three called. He run him up on the outside corner. Allen fans here, back-to-back strikeouts for Hamilton. And the Giants do not score. They leave him loaded here in the eighth. They've left 11 on the night. We go to the last of the eighth next. Still Holyoke 3, Newport nothing here on the NECBL Broadcast Network.
Welcome back, my friends, to the show that never ends. We're so glad you could attend. Come inside, come inside.
So we go to the eighth inning here at Cardinals Field, the last of the eighth in Newport, Rhode Island. The Newport Gulls trailing the Holyoke Giants 3-0. And a report out of Pittsfield, it's 8-2 Manchester in the top of the sixth inning. Latest report out of Manchester here in Cardine's, out of Pittsfield, I should say, as the Dukes trailing the Silkworms 8-2 in the sixth. Here at Cardine's Field, 3-0 Giants, and the Gulls have six outs left to get back into this ball game. Only four hits of the night for Newport. Ryan Arcady had one of them back in the third, and infield single was stranded on base. Nothing in one to count here as Arcadia squares for a bunt, puts one up the third base line, but it rolls foul, and Ryan will fall in a hole here, nothing in two.
Alert play by Adamski, the third baseman for the Giants, to grab that ball once it rolled in the foul territory. Don't want to take any chances of it rolling back fair. Otherwise, Arcadia has a bunt single.
No balls, two strikes, a count on Arcadia. One for two tonight. Top of the order due up next for the Gulls, who need base runners here in the eighth. Galeno out there for an eighth inning of work to pitch. Breaking ball is in there. Missing. Skipping over the plate. And unable to get it was Irvin for ball one. Good crowd here tonight, Cardinals Field. We'll have an attendance report shortly. Low 1-2 pitch. Swing and a line shot right field. This ball will fall for a hit. On at first is Arcadia, his second hit of the ball game. And that will bring the top of the order up. Tying run comes to the on-deck circle. Tim Henry walked in the third, flew out in the, to left in the first, and grounded out to second in the sixth. He's 0-2, and he will bat here with Arcadia, who has a lot of speed at first. Ryan, 10-for-10 in stolen bases. Here comes Joel Southern onto the mound. This may do it for the starter, Galeno, as he talks things over with him. We wait on the word, and he signals to the bullpen, so we have a pitching change coming to you in this game from Cardine's Field in Newport, Rhode Island. The Gulls, a runner at first, nobody out. We're here in the eighth, 3-0 Holyoke. We'll be back to tell you about the new pitcher next on the NECBL Broadcast Network. Back here now at Cardine's Field in Newport, Rhode Island, as the public address system plays the Hey Song, so do we on our puppet music, competing Hey Songs here, as the new pitcher for the Holyoke Giants, their second of the night, will be Tyler Storr. And what can you tell us about him? Storr, a right-hander, will face off against Tim Henry, Matt Bouchard, Jeff Miller, top of the order, due up for the Gulls here, who have a runner at first with nobody out. He comes set, the pitch. Swing and a line shot, base hit into left field over the leaping shortstop who couldn't get a glove on it. And the Gulls have back-to-back singles here for two different pitchers. Storr coming into the game.
Well, for Tyler Storr, this is his fourth appearance. He has no decisions, an ERA of 5.06. He's pitched five innings, given up six hits, four runs, three of them earned. Walked seven, struck out two. Opponents hitting .316 against him.
Well, working on a line on Galeno, as Matt Bouchard steps up, single his last time, 1-for-3, a pair of flyouts. Bouchard steps up to the plate here with two runners on, nobody out. Matt is the tying run for Newport. A go-ahead run comes into the on-deck circle. That'll be Jeff Miller if Bouchard can get on here. Tyler Storr ready. He comes set the pitch. A bunt back to the mound, and Storr picks it up, throws the first in time, an excellent sacrifice bunt for Matt Bouchard, who advances two runners into scoring position for Miller in the heart of the order. 1-3 on the bunt ground out, as advancing to third is Ryan Arcadia, advancing to second, Tim Henry. The Gulls have two of their fastest runners on here for Jeff Miller, who's 0-for-3, ground to a 6-4-3 double play, a strikeout, and a pop-up. 3-0 Holyoke here. The Gulls have two on in scoring position. Miller's the tying run at the plate. The pitch to him. Breaking ball in there for a strike. So Tyler Storr replaces Dan Galeno, who had struck out four on the night. No runs crossed the plate during his tenure. He does stand to get to the win. And it'll be a safe situation here, too. The 0-1 is in there for a strike, and the crowd disagrees with that strike call. Miller does not have a word for home plate umpire John DeGolamo. 0-2 the count here to Jeff. Pitch about belt high, but inside for a strike. Two on, one out. The 0-2 pitch skips in the dirt. Ball one. Blocked by the catcher, Irvin.
Yeah, Pat Irvin making another nice defensive play for the Giants.
Nick Lehmer, Mike Lord here on the NACBR Broadcast Network. We're in a very close game here as the Gulls trail at 3-0, but have runners on at second and third. Miller at the plate, one out. Last of the eighth, the 1-2 pitch coming from Tyler Storr to the returning goal, Jeff Miller, right now. Up and away, ball two. Jim Murphy waits on deck. A walk here would load the bases. And Storr has to be very careful with the power coming up right around the corner. Murphy, Dominguez, Brown, and Malacone have combined for about 16 home runs. The pitch, swing, and a high pop-up left side, way out of play. Falls over America's Cup Avenue into the bus station to our left. Across the four-lane street that borders Cardinals Field. 2-2, the count remains to Miller, who stays alive. The next four batters have combined for 17 runs. Murphy, Malacone, Brown, Dominguez, home runs. Runners at second and third, and asking for time is Miller. Two balls, two strikes, the count on Jeff, one out. Henry and Arcadia lead at second and third, respectively. From the set, Tyler Storr, the 2-2 pitch. Swinging on a ground ball, fisted foul around the plate area. We'll do it again. And Miller in a battle here with Tyler Storr. A very good crowd here, at least 15 to 1800, maybe more at Cardinals Field tonight. Watch this ball game being brought to you here on the NECBL Broadcast Network, the Tigers TV crew. Two on, one out. Once again, the 2-2 pitch to Miller. Here it comes. Breaking ball, just missing inside. Skips in there for ball three. Big Jim Murphy waits on deck. He's picked up the goals a lot of times this season. One away here. The payoff pitch. Ball four is outside. The bases are loaded up for Jim Murphy. Murphy, the Southern Division starting first baseman for the All-Star game.
Well, Nick, when the Giants failed to score with the bases loaded with only one out in the top half of the inning, it just seemed like to fire up the offense for the Gulls here.
Jim Murphy has a .330 batting average in the game tonight. 12 doubles, 6 home runs, 28 runs batted in. A double here could clear the bases as there's hitting room in right center as Murphy, the league leader in RBI, starting first baseman for the NECBL Southern Division All-Stars, takes the first pitch outside and low, ball one. Only one out here as the Gulls have a runner on every base. Miller at first, Henry at second, Arcadia at third. They trail at 3-0. The tying run at first. Murphy's the go-ahead run at the plate. Storr comes set. The 1-0 pitch. Fastball misses. Low and away. Ball two. The crowd gets into this one here at Cardinals Field. A walk here would bring the Gulls' first run home. Newport has not been shut out this season, and they're not going to go out without a fight here tonight. They have their rally caps on in the Newport dugout. The fans with their rally caps on, upside down. The pitch. Misses, ball three. 3-0 on Murphy. You don't want to fall behind Jim. If you try to sneak one across the plate, he could turn on it. And that ball would not drop for a long time. 6 homers on the season for Murphy. Tied with his teammate Dominguez and the Twisters, Arbor and Perez, for the league lead.
Yeah, if Murphy gets a hold of one, somebody in the next area code's going to get a souvenir tomorrow morning.
28 RBIs on the season for Murphy. He likes some more right here. Storr gets the sign from Irvin. The 3-0 pitch with the bases loaded. Strike called on the outside corner. And there'll be a hitter's count now, 3-1. They lead on every base. Store ready. From the set, the 3-1. Paul Porak side, he walked in a run. Crossing the plate is Ryan Arcadia. It's 3-1, Holyoke. All the goals have their rally caps on as they come out of the dugout to greet Arcadia, who crosses the plate. And Store comes on in relief and walks in a run here. Came on a 3-1 pitch. It was ball four. Murphy takes his base at first. Advancing to second is Miller. Henry goes into third. The bases remain loaded here with one out. As we have an infield conference on the mound. And another pitching change coming to you in this game from Cod Ainsfield. We'll be right back. Tell you about the new pitcher next on the NECBL Broadcast Network. It's 3-1 Holyoke. So Kyle Rutter out of North Carolina State University will be the new pitcher, third pitcher of the night for the Holyoke Giants. He replaces Tyler Storr here in the eighth as the Gulls have a run home. And Arcadia has walked in on a 3-1 pitch to Murphy. The goal still have the bases loaded here. A runner on every base for John Molicone. Two homers on the season. Bats here, the bases loaded. 3-1 the score. The Holyoke Giants on top. Tying run at second. The pitch from the sidearm delivery is outside in there for a strike on the outside corner.
Yeah, Rutter pitched last night the ninth inning to save the game for John Monty. He pitched one shutout inning against Lowell.
The 0-1. Sidearm delivery again, is it missing low for ball one? John Molicone, bats here with the bases loaded. 0-4, the bases are loaded this season. Awaits the pitch, swing and a miss. Strike two, one out here. At first is Jim Murphy, who walked and earned an RBI, his 29th of the season. Jeff Miller, who walked at second. Tim Henry, who singled at third, the pitch. Way inside, gets away, and bounces around the backstop. No chance for the runner to advance, as it's not allowed to foul territory here at Cardinals Field. That pitch landed in foul territory somewhere up the, about 5 feet up the first base line, and the sidearm delivery hurt him there.
And it certainly did. Luckily, like you said, very little foul room behind the plate, and it's plywood, so the Giants got a favorable ricochet off the backstop.
Yeah, the Everseer run score from third here on a wild pitch. The pitch. Swing and a foul to the left. One in, two balls, two strikes, the count to John Molicone, the catcher for the Newport Gulls, a Cranston, Rhode Island native out of Fordham University. Could be the hero right here. Molicone bats with a Gull on every base. One out in the eighth from the set. Rutter, the 2-2, swinging a foul to the screen. Rutter. All righty. Pitching against Molicone here, who's battling his way through this one. Comes set. The 2-2 delivery to the plate. Swing, a shot, left side, but foul. Well, foul. And they can't remain two balls, two strikes on Molicone. Rutter, a 4.15 red run average, 4-1 in 10 appearances. Record two saves, has pitched 17 in the third, giving up 17 hits, 10 runs, 8 of them earned. Walked 11, struck out 18, 4 doubles, no home runs given up off of Rutter. Bases loaded, the pitch, swinging another foul to the screen. A real battle for Molicone here against Rutter. There's one out, the bases are juiced, 2-2 the count. Rutter, ready. From the set, the 2-2 pitch. Strike three called, he got him on the inside corner. Molicone fans, and Rutter comes on top of that battle, but here comes Scott Brown. Brown reaching a fielder's choice in the seventh. Full out to right in the fourth, grounded out in the second. Can Brown be the hero here? Brown has one career grand slam in the NECBL. Came in game one of the LCS last year against Vermont here at Cardinals Field. Can he do it again against Holyoke tonight? The pitch. Swing and a ground ball. Bombs to the second baseman. He has it, boots it, and everybody's safe. Scoring from third is Tim Henry, and it's a 3-2 ball game. That'll be an error charge to the second baseman, Billy Modrum. Oh, is it an infield single? Well, wait on word from the infield, from the official scorer. It could be an infield single as the second baseman, Modern, tried to get the ball on the tough hop, and it'll be a E4 or a single. And it'll be charged as a hit. It is an infield single, so Brown will record an RBI here. It's a one-run ball game, as Dominguez has been lifted in favor of a pinch hitter. The bases remain loaded for Andy Lentz, who comes up, and Dominguez prior to Lentz was 0-for-3 with a pair of strikeouts. Lentz bats here with a runner on every base, a one-run ball game after an infield single to the second baseman, and Modrum just couldn't come up with it. Scoring from third was Henley. The pitch to Lentz, swing and a miss, strike one. Lentz bats from the left side against the righty Rutter. Tying run, 90 feet from the plate for the Gulls. The go-ahead run at second, insurance at first. Bases are been loaded for a while here. Lentz at the plate, the pitch, missing low, ball one. Pinch hitting, the Gulls are 1-for-6 this season. The 1-1 delivery to Andy Lentz. Side on toss is missing just outside for a ball. 2-1 the count on Andy. His first pitch at bat for himself this year. The next delivery to Lentz, swinging a foul to the left. And the count will even at 2-2. Lentz, 1-for-3 with the bases loaded. Batting 333. That's here. With Brown at first, Murphy at second, Miller at third. From the set, Rutter, the 2-2 pitch. Check swing, did he go? Yes, he did. Strike three called. The Gulls get a fair across. They leave him loaded, though, and do not manage to tie this ball game up. We finish 8 innings here at Cardinals Field. It's 3-2, Holyoke. We go to the ninth next as we continue on the NECBL Broadcast Network. So the Newport Gulls trying to battle their way back into this one. Leave them loaded in the eighth after getting a couple runs across on the RBI walk with the bases loaded by Murphy that scored Arcadia, and the RBI infield single by Scott Brown that scored Tim Henry from third. They left them loaded, though, and it's a 3-2 ball game. We go to the ninth inning as the Newport Gulls will try and keep this ball game close, and they'll have one more chance in the last of the ninth. 3 more outs left for them. First, they'll have to get through the top of the ninth as number 17, the second baseman, Billy Mottram, comes up. Mottram takes the first pitch, ball one, from Blake Hamilton, out there for a second inning of relief of the starter, Lurie, who won 7 pretty good innings here tonight. The 1-0. Outside ball two, Lurie isn't off the hook yet, though, as it's still a 3-2 to ball game here. The Gulls finally ending the shutout in the eighth. They've never been shut out this season. The next pitch, outside, low ball three. And the last thing you want to do here is walk the leadoff man with the heart of the order due up. Mottram is already 2-for-4, the 3-0 pitch. Ball four, he walked him on 4 pitches. Oh, a leadoff walk issued to Billy Mottram, and that'll bring up the number 3 hitter, Brian Ademski, who's 2-for-4, a strikeout, a flyout, a double, and a key RBI double in the seventh, which is the difference in this ball game right now. He tried to stretch that double into a triple and was thrown out at third, but it did get the run across, and that's why it's 3-2 Holyoke right now. Came in the seventh. We're here in the top of the ninth. The Giants are batting. One last time for the Gulls who get their last chance.
So both teams squandering opportunities in the eighth. The Giants had the bases loaded with one out in the top of the eighth and didn't push across any runs. The Gulls, bases loaded with nobody out and only pushed across one run.
10 hits, 10 left on for the Giants as strike one is in there to Ademski. For the Gulls, they've left 9. and have had seven hits, including three in the last of the eighth. Go with a pair of walks. Runner at first, Matram, the pitcher of Dembski, in there for a strike, nothing in two. It was three singles and two walks in the ninth for Newport that made this ball game a 3-2 ball game. Again, 10 left for Holyoke, 9 left for Newport as a 2-0-2 is missing outside ball one. Those are key statistics in this ball game. They've been able to get runners on, just haven't been able to get them across the plate here. Each team leaving the bases loaded tonight. But Newport, with the advantage in that category, is the 1-2 pitch. It's swung on, hit foul to the right, over by my car. And it'll hopefully miss it entirely as I'm precariously parked over there across the street. One ball, two strikes to count. Nobody out, top of the ninth, 3-2 Holyoke. Blake Hamilton comes to the set. The pitch. Swinging a hard hit ground ball. Murphy can't get it. He recovers and flips to first. The pitcher covering, not in time. Safe at first is Ademski. That ball, ground ball chopper, which was to him, and it'll be charged as an E3. Another error in this ball game, and once again, defense is hearing the Gulls. Output runners at first and second with nobody out, and Mike Coombs will come out, and this may do it for Hamilton. And it will. We have a pitching change coming to you in this game from Cardines Field. We'll come back, tell you about the new pitcher next as the Gulls send up their third pitcher of the night. Right back after this, it's 3-2 Holyoke, and the Giants threaten here in the top of the ninth. Two on, nobody out. Back in a moment on the NECBL Broadcast Network. And here again at Cardines Field in Newport, the Gulls are sending their third pitcher of the night on the mound to face off against Mike Lyon, the cleanup hitter here. We'll be batting with runs at first and second. The Giants, a 3-2 lead. The Gulls coming back in the eighth. They played their first two runs of the ball game, but in danger of losing that slight advantage here as there are two on and nobody out for Lyon. The new pitcher for the Newport Gulls will be Ryan Moore. Moore comes in here, the University of Maryland. Ryan, an all-star for the Newport Gulls, will be an all-star reliever. 0.86 ERA, 4-1, 11 appearances. Has one save. This is his 12th relief appearance. Ryan pitched 21 innings, giving up 14 hits, two runs, both of them earned, has walked seven, struck out 18. Giving up three doubles, no triples or home runs. Batter seeing just 194 against him. Runners at first and second. The infield in, the pitch. A bunt off the third baseline. Moore fields. Throws a bullet to first in time to get Lyon for the out. That's only one out, however, as Ademski advances to second. Matram advances to third. Two runners in scoring position, one away for Thomas Hill. 1-3 in the sacrifice bunt. Hill is 0-4. Strikeout, a grind out, a fly out, and a pop up.
Yeah, that was a perfect bunt by Mike Lyon. Being a power hitter, I don't think the Gulls expected him to lay down the bunt, and he did it very effectively.
Well, Malico out for a word with Moore here. And he'll give some signs to the infield. The Gulls want to hang on in this game and have a one last chance to come back in the ninth. They don't want to do that with trailing more than one run. They trail up 3-2 here, but the Giants threaten. Two on in scoring position, one away, the pitch. In there for a strike, a good breaking pitch from Moore. Hill grounded out to the shortstop to end the first. Struck out swinging to end the third. Flew out the right to end the fifth. Led off the eighth with a pop-up to the shortstop. One out, the 0-1 delivery from the set to the plate. Another breaking pitch in there on the outside corner for strike two. Two good locations from Moore, and he had Hill fooled both times. Let's see if he goes after him here with the fastball. A lead at second and third for Ademski and Matram. Hill, Moore already. The 0-2 pitch to Hill. Fastball, swung on and missed, strike three. He gets Hill on three pitches. That's the inning second out, and here comes Vincent Gutierrez. Gutierrez, reached on an error and scored the first run of the ball game in the second, grounded out in the fourth, single in the sixth, walked in the eighth, was stranded in the eighth when the Giants left him loaded and did not score. The Gulls left the bases loaded in the last of the eighth, but plated two runs and trailless ball game 3-2, two runners in scoring position, two outs here in the top of the ninth. The pitch, off-speed breaking ball in the outside corner for strike one to Gutierrez, and he'll go after the lefty here. Mora, a right-hander, gets his signs. Now comes a high set to the belt, the 0-1. Fastball misses a little bit low and outside, ball one. Mora, be joined by his teammates, Pat McEnany and Mike Lynn, as well as John Mollicone, Jim Murphy, Matt Bouchard, and Tim Henry in the All-Star game. Chris Dominguez to be in the home run derby, the 1-1 pitch. Outside corner, a fastball, strike two. Looks like a slider for Mora. Mora throws picture-perfect pitches out there. The All-Star game for the Southern Division will be coached by the Newport Gulls coaching staff, Mike Coombs, Scott Virgilak, Greg Rawl, among others. The 1-2 delivery, swinging a foul tip left side, out of play. Mike Coombs invited a vast array of Southern Division coaches to join him in the dugout. I haven't gotten word yet on who will be joining him. We'll find out more about that on Friday. Next time the Gulls will be here at Cardines Field, face the Northam Steeplecats for the final time this season. We're in second place in the NECBL South. The Gulls in first place, 4.5 games up. The 1-2 pitch, swinging a ground ball bouncer, up with it, the second baseman Bouchard flips to first to Murphy in time for the out that retires the side. The Giants get 2-1 to lead off this inning, strand both runners in scoring position. We have played 8.5, 3-2 Holyoke. We go to the last of the ninth. Last chance for Newport next here on the NECBL Broadcast Network. So Phil Rutter will be out there to pitch the ninth here against the Newport Gulls. Rutter came in the eighth and got the Newport Gulls to get out of the inning without any more damage done. Scott Brown, an RBI single in the eighth. Murphy, an RBI walk at the bases loaded to walk in a run. That's the only two runs the Gulls have played it today. It's 3-2 Holyoke. We're here the ninth, a defensive change for the Giants.
Phil Allen, who's played center field all season for the Giants, is in now in the bottom of the ninth inning for Jason Rago.
The Gulls who send Mitchell, Arcadia, and then the top of the order, Tim Henry, due up here. Arcadia got the rally started in the eighth when the Newport Gulls sent eight men to the plate, scoring two of them and leaving the bases loaded. Oh, we're here in the bottom of the ninth inning. Kyle Rutter will face against the pitch hitter, Matt Iannetta. So Mitzel's been taken out here. Iannetta joined the team a couple weeks ago as an extra catcher, has been playing a lot lately. Iannetta batting 250, one homer, two runs batted in. Five hits in the season, making his seventh game appearance, and pops this one up. It will roll foul up the third base line, tried for a bunt, and Iannetta falls in a hole here, nothing in one. Iannetta, younger brother of Chris Iannetta, the 2003 Newport Gull, recently called up the AAA. Native of Providence, Rhode Island. Joined the team about 2 weeks ago. Played his first game, game two of a doubleheader up in Manchester for the Gulls, and fared pretty well there. Has been in and out since then. A couple games off in between starts for Iannetta, who's pinch hitting here, the 0-1 pitch. Fastball misses low and outside from Kyle Rutter. Third pitcher of the night for the Giants as he tries to earn the save here. It is Giuliano's game to win. Low pitch. Low outside, ball two. 2-1 the count on Iannetta. Ryan Arcadia waits on deck, then Tim Henry. Mitzel, who Iannetta replaced here, pinch hitting, was 0-3. The pitch, Sidearm tosses, swung on, foul tipped around the plate area, and the count even at 2 balls, 2 strikes to Iannetta. Outfield playing deep. Infield at normal depth. Iannetta, one home run on the season. He wouldn't mind hitting another one here to tie this ball game up. He is the tying run for the Gulls here in the bottom of the ninth. The 2-2 pitch outside, ball three. That one almost got away from Rudder. A full count. Kyle Rudder comes set, the 3-2 delivery. Swing, a high drive, deep left field. Way back, this ball will be off the top of the wall. Iannetta rounding first. He's gonna be in his second with a leadoff stand-up double. And the Newport Gulls get the time run on here in the bottom of the ninth. A leadoff double for Matt Iannetta. That Iannetta missed a home run by about 2 feet out there as the ball hit well to left center field. Was recovered by left fielder Justin Albert. The Gulls have a runner at second base. Ryan Arcady will get the rally start in the eighth as a single. He's 2-for-3 tonight, and he'll bat here with the winning run, well, as the winning run, tying run on for Newport. Arcady at 297. No homers, 3 runs batted in. Squares for Bunt. Bunts it up the first baseline. There'll be one play at first. Arcadia thrown out, and he gets the job done and advances Iannetta to third. The tying run now 90 feet from the plate, and we cycle around to the top of the order and Tim Henry. Arcadia, pretty good bunt up the third baseline.
Yeah, Giants squandering many golden opportunities here, and it could come back to haunt them here in the bottom of the ninth inning. Kyle Rudder's gonna have to pull a rabbit out of the hat here.
5-3 on the bunt. Top of the order, Tim Henry. He is 1-for-3, a walk, a single, a ground out, and a fly out. Iannetta stands in at third. Tying run for the Gulls, who have trailed this ball game all along. It's 3-2. Henry. The pitch is missing, ball one. One and nothing the count. The next pitch, swinging a foul tip to the backstop. 1-1 the count equals, evens up on Tim Henry. Henry flew out to left in the first, walked on 4 pitches in the third, grounded out to second in the sixth, single in the eighth, scored a run. The pitch, inside and low, ball two. Iannetta waits 90 feet from the plate. Very unlikely he'll try to steal a home. The 2-1, swinging a ground ball bouncer. The second baseman stabs it, throws the first in time for the inning's second out, and the Newport Gulls are down to their last out. Henry grounds out.
Excellent play by Billy March from the second baseman. As he looked, Mitchell back to third base before throwing over to Hill for out number two.
So it'll be up to Matt Bouchard. Bouchard is 1-for-4. Sacrifice bunt, key bunt in the eighth to advance the runners. Both of them who eventually scored. Single in the sixth, pair of flyouts in this ball game. Last chance for the Gulls, 2 outs, tying run at third. The pitch, swing and a drive, pulled to the right side, foul.
I'll tell you, Nick, if the Giants hold on here to win, this would be the greatest escape since Alcatraz.
Nothing in one of the count on Bouchard. This has been a nail-biter tonight. 3-2 Giants. Iannetta leads at third, the pitch. Up and away, ball one. Crowd of 1,902 fans are attendance here tonight at Cardinals Field on this Wednesday night. 1-1 the count on Bouchard, the pitch. Swing and ground ball, chop, foul up the third baseline. The Newport Gulls are down to their last strike. Kyle Rudder will get the signs from his catcher, Pat Irvin. Matt Iannetta, who led this inning off with a double, advanced to third on the sacrifice bunt by Arcadia, stands in at third. Henry came on, bounced out to second. That was out number two, Bouchard at the plate. Bottom of the ninth, 3-2 our score, 2 outs. The 1-2 pitch to the plate. Swinging and a miss, he struck him out. The Holyoke Giants defeat the Newport Gulls, who try to rally in the later innings. Fall short here. The Giants have won a very impressive game here tonight against the Newport Gulls.
Unbelievable, and the Giants really needed this win because they're fighting for playoff position. And what a great momentum builder this will be for the Giants as they head home tomorrow night to host the Sanford Mainers before going to Keene for two games Friday and Saturday before the All-Star break. So, like I said, a nice win here. And if they can take a couple more games, they would pretty much sew up a playoff spot. But I'll tell you, the pitching of Dan Gallino, he was just outstanding tonight, and he might be my most valuable player of tonight's game.
So the Newport Gulls drop a very, very tough game here at Cardines Field, and they'll play their next one tomorrow on the road. We'll be going to the Danbury Westerners out in Danbury, Connecticut, out to Rogers Park, as the Gulls will be playing, making up a double, will be playing against Danbury tomorrow. And probably be a 7 o'clock start time up there in Danbury, Connecticut, as the Gulls are a one-game road trip back here at Cardines Field on Friday night to face the North Am Steeplecast. And stay tuned for the next few minutes. We'll have a player of the game interview coming up in a minute, as well as a post-game show. And Mike Lord, a few last words for you.
Well, this is a nice win for the Giants. Simply now, they can go home knowing that they can play with the elite in the NECBL. And when I say elite, I mean the Newport Gulls. No, they still are, in my opinion, going to be the team to beat if you want to win a title. And you talk about coming back home Friday against North Adams. By the All-Star break, they could pretty much clinch the NECBL Southern Division. The Gulls have lots of weapons. They're very deep in their relief pitching. And like you said, they've only given up one run between innings 7 and 9. And it showed why. They held the Giants scoreless with bases loaded and then runners on second and third. So the Giants, they need to get back to the drawing board and getting hits with men in scoring position if they're going to go deep in the playoffs this year.
We'll have the totals and highlights next coming up here on the NECBL Broadcast Network. Mike, thank you for joining us here tonight, and I'll catch up with you perhaps at the All-Star game or perhaps in the playoffs.
Nick, it was a pleasure working with you again. Unfortunately, we were moved to the Northern Division in the last year. Otherwise, I'd have a couple more trips down here.
Mike, thank you for joining us.
You're welcome. My pleasure.
Stay tuned. The totals are next here on the NECBL Broadcast Network. And back here now at Cardines Field in Newport with the totals for this game. 3-2, the Holyoke Giants earned a split on the season series. The Newport Gulls won the first game of this series up in Holyoke, Massachusetts a few weeks back. 5-0, Pat McEnany to win in that one. Tonight, unfortunately for the Gulls, Mike LaRie, who had 7 pretty strong innings, only gave up 2 earned runs, will earn the loss. And Dan Guglio will get the win for the Holyoke Giants. The save will go to Kyle Rutter, who came out in the ninth and eventually struck out Matt Bouchard for the inning, for the out that retired the ball game. For the Holyoke Giants, 3 runs on 11 hits, no errors, and 12 left on base. Almost a key statistic as the Gulls try to come back in the later innings. For Newport, 2 runs on 8 hits, 3 errors committed. A very key statistic, that unearned run, which came back way back in the second inning of the ball game. Error by Jeff Miller as Vincent Gutierrez reached and scored the first run of the ball game. And 9 men left on base for Newport. The game was watched by a crowd of 1,902 fans. It took 2 hours and 50 minutes to play here on Wednesday night, July 19th, Cardines Field, Newport, Rhode Island. Nick Lehman alongside Mike Lord and the NECBL Broadcast Network, brought to you by the Tippin Tigers TV crew. And the Gulls fall tonight 3-2, the final. Back on the field, our interviews next here on the NECBL Broadcast Network. Stay with us. Back here now at Cardines Field at Newport, Rhode Island, Nick Lehman alongside Newport Gulls pitching coach Scott Virgilak. The Gulls losing a tough game tonight, 3-2, a heartbreaker. Tried to come back late in the game, just not enough towards the end.
Yeah, you know, we were just talking about that, and, you know, it seems like, you know, especially at home, we wait around. But their guy in the mound had, you know, had something to do with that. Crafty hit his spots, mixed it up, and we just couldn't get to him until it was too late.
Yeah, just a few hits and a walk through the first about 8 innings he pitched, and Newport really couldn't get to him until that last half of the 8th inning when the Giants went through 3 pitchers.
Yeah, and you know, a lot of times just not trying to do too much. You know, take what he gives us. You know, he's hitting his spots, and you know, there's times where you just gotta, you know, take what he gives you, look the ball, hit the other way, and you know, we definitely he definitely kept us in check for a while.
9 runners left on for Newport, but 12 left on tonight for the Giants. That still has to say something very positive about Newport Gold's pitching.
Yeah, our pitching's been solid all year. Definitely, you know, hasn't been a problem. I think we have the lowest team ERA, and it might even went down a little bit today because some of those runs were, at least one of them was unearned. So yeah, pitching, you know, hasn't been a problem. The guys that gone out there have done a good job. We're just, you know, getting a little thin right now as far as, you know, depth in our bullpen. Some guys banged up. Hopefully we get him back the next couple days, but pitching will be all right.
And Richie Lentz will be available as of Saturday.
Hopefully, yeah. Cross our fingers. He threw his third and hopefully final bullpen today. Felt good, which is the main thing. You know, hopefully, you know, we're going to play it by ear. We're going to let him tell us when he feels like he's good to go. Hopefully Saturday. Maybe even see him Friday. We never know.
What's going to be the plan of attack tomorrow as the Newport Gulls go on the road?
Tomorrow we have Pat McEnany starting game one, and Robbie Wilson, who's done a great job for us out of the bullpen, long relief, he's going to go game two. Pat's coming back on short rest, but we felt with the 7-inning games, you know, he'd be all right, and he's going to be, you know, be the starting pitcher in the All-Star game Sunday. We just wanted to give him an extra day in between there before Sunday, so he'll start tomorrow.
And for our fans at home, will that be a 5 o'clock start time on game one?
Yes, I think so. 5 o'clock, yes.
And the game two will start about half an hour after the first game concludes. 7-inning games tomorrow as the Gulls take on the Danbury Westerners up at Rogers Park in Danbury, Connecticut. And Newport going into that doubleheader tomorrow on a tough loss tonight, but still in a pretty good position here. First place in NECBL Southern Division off that pretty good win against the Northam Steeplecats on 9 to go.
Yeah, like Skip told the team when we went out there, you know, everyone, they're chasing us. But we have to, you know, stay sharp. And, you know, we got 2 good arms going tomorrow. They're going to keep us in the game. We know that. So, you know, we just got to punch some runs across and, you know, get things going here.
And finally, of the 7 members of the Gulls going to the All-Star game, plus Chris Dominguez going to the Home Run Derby, 3 of the Newport Gulls pitching staff members will be going in the All-Star game, the starter, the closer, and a reliever as well.
Yeah, and it very easily could have been 5 or 6, but...
just looking up and down that line, a lot of players are in that spot.
Yeah, there were at least 2 or 3 guys, you know, that were passed over, but that's, you know, that's going to happen. They're not going to take our whole pitching staff, so, you know, we're lucky and fortunate to get 3 guys going, and they're 3 good ones.
And we'll talk to you and Coach Coons back here at Cardinals Field on Friday before the Gulls wrap up their season series against the Steeplecats. Talk more about that All-Star game then. For now, Coach Virgilak, good luck tomorrow, and thank you for joining us for our postgame show.
All right, Nick, thank you.
We'll catch up with you tomorrow. So the Newport Gulls lose the game tonight. The final score, 3-2. We'll keep it right here for the closing segment. Nick Leamer, alongside Mike Lord, I'd like to thank him for joining us from the Holyoke Giants organization. Let's pause a moment and thank those who made the broadcast possible. The executive producer of Newport Gulls Baseball is Tom Leamer, who is also our director tonight. Our associate producer, Raymond Ballard Sr., our on-site engineer, Tim Wine, our cameraman, Gardner Cogshaw, our audio technician, Christina Simonelli. I'm Nick Leamer, bringing you this game from Cardinals Field in Newport. The Gulls lose a heartbreaker here tonight, 3-2, the final score. Newport on the road, a doubleheader tomorrow in Danbury. Back here at Cardinals Field on Friday night, 6:35 with the first pitch. On the air with the pregame show at 6:15. We hope you join us then. Until our next broadcast, I'd like to thank you all for watching. The Gulls fall tonight, 3-2, the final. For Mike Lord, I'm Nick Leamer. The Gulls lose tonight. Next game coming up, a doubleheader tomorrow. The season continues next on the NECBL Broadcast Network. Until next time, so long, everybody.
Will you live for that moment? One pitch, one swing. You see it in slow motion. You count every scene. And keep your eye. Well, buddy, keep your eye on the dream. First base, second base. Go for third, called safe. Well, home plate's 90 feet. Steal it in a heartbeat.
Twisters go swamp bats. Mainers, Utes, and Mountaineers. Silkworms, Westerners. Giants, All-Americans. It's a NEC